Mike. Jackson.
There we go. Now I get. Now I.
Just be a part of it. Just ricochet.
I'm hearing it now on both mics. Thank you.
The BallGame Blitz Sports Network by Worthy Road Studios. With over 750,000 views in 2022, we are where you need to advertise. Please subscribe to our Worthy Road Studios YouTube channel and join the other 4,000 subscribers watching local sports.
The Jackson Rockabillys, Union and Bethel Universities, USJ, TCA, JCS, and Peabody. Our multi-camera broadcasts include slow motion instant replay, on-screen scoreboard and graphics, and professional announcers.
Thanks to the sponsors who make it all possible.
BallGame Blitz Sports Network by Worthy Road Studios. The premier sports broadcast network in West Tennessee.
Combination, she's a good, fast fisher, a dynamite kisser, country as a tiny green. She's got her daddy's money, her mama's good looks, and look who's looking at me. She's got her daddy's money, her mama's good looks, and she's looking at me.
The following is a sports presentation of 100.9 The Fog.
Pop. That's what I want. All of you around that ball.
Time now for Bethel University Wildcat Sports.
Incredible.
Brought to you by these proud sponsors.
Carroll Bank and Trust, Taylor Real Estate, Holly Credit Union, West Tennessee Public Utility District, Johnsonville TVA, and Pepper's Ford.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Wildcat Stadium on the campus of Bethel University in McKenzie, Tennessee. Beautiful day here for football. Beautiful day out to be outside no matter what, but we hope you're on your way to Wildcat Stadium. Some of the folks already here as we get ready for home game number 2 and game number 3 of the football campaign. Hi, everybody. I'm Dave McCulley along with Jeremy McCulley. My son's going to be helping us with color today. Derek Hubble, the very talented one, is on stats. We have the folks at 100.9 WEIO, Tom Yarbrough in charge, and Paul Schulze and his crew here today with Worthy Road Studios and the Ball Game Blitz. And on BoxCast, along with our good buddy, Mr. Austin Childers, who's been a ramrod of a guy today, getting everything ready for us. We are ready for football. The Cats coming off a convincing 77-0 win last week over St. Andrews. Heavily favored today were Bluefield, but Bluefield, a much better football team. They come in 2-0. This game today pits the two of the top scoring teams in the country. The Bluefield Rams out of Bluefield, Virginia. They average 42 points a game. They're 11th in the country in scoring. And the Cats, well, ain't getting any better than this. They're number one in the country, averaging 64 points per game. Claire Craddock is down here spotting for Derek Hubble, who's enjoying some food right now, getting ready to do yeoman's work a little later. A moment ago, Austin Childers had a chance to talk to the head coach of the Cats, Mike Jasper, in his fifth year. We're going to let you hear that interview because he had to record it, actually, with another device other than my recorder, which is broke down again. But we're going to let you hear that real quick off the bat. Mike's thoughts about the game today, because Austin's got a lot of other duties he's got to attend to here in the countdown to kickoff. So here's the comments. There's Billy Douglas in the house. We've got a few comments from Coach Mike Jasper about today's big ball game.
Mike Jasper at Bethel University. They're taking on the Bluefield Rams today. Coach, coming into today's game, they are the top, one of the top rated offenses in the nation, coming in at 2-0 on the season. What is your game plans today for the offense and the defense, and the key points for today's game?
Well, key points for the game, I feel like, is we just got to make it all about us. We got to come out and execute. Like I say, week in and week out, we got one of the best teams in the country. We got the best defense in the country, I believe. So we just got to come out, win on our leverage, play great technique, sound football, and execute the game plan. Offensively, we got to come out and we got to own the line of scrimmage. We got to be able to run the ball. Obviously, when you're playing against a team and a great coach like Dewey Luss, he wants to sling that ball around the yard. So we got to make sure our defense stays fresh. We got to have good, long, sustained drives and dominate up front.
Sounds like a good game plan, Coach. Good luck.
I appreciate it.
That's Austin Childers talking to the head coach, Mike Jasper, just a moment ago. It's the Cats and the Rams, and a very familiar face back on campus today. Our good buddy Dino Kaklis is back, the former head coach of the Cats. As a matter of fact, he was the head coach when I first came here back in 2010. Had a great career here. He is the associate head coach of the Rams and also the defensive coordinator. Let's take a two-minute break along the line on Worthy Road Studios, the Ballgame Blitz, and on 100.9, and we'll be back with the Cats and the Rams on this beautiful Saturday afternoon. A big battle here today between the number 7 Cats and the Rams, coming in undefeated as well at 2-0. Back after this on the Bethel Football Network.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank and Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank and Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank and Trust, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntington. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
This is the fifth meeting between the two programs, the Cats and the Rams out of Bluefield. They first met back in 2012. The last meeting was 2019 in Bluefield, with Bethel winning 49-24. Both squads, as we mentioned a moment ago, 2-0 in the year. This will be the 491st game in program history with the Cats. They're 196, 286, and 8 coming in here today. Bethel moved to 2-0 last week when they beat the Knights of St. Andrews, and Bethel won big. They led 42-0 at the end of the first, 63-0 at halftime. We played 10-minute quarters in the third and fourth, and the seventh-ranked Cats, they moved one spot from 8 to number 7. They won 77-0. Meanwhile, Bluefield improved their record to 2-0. They were actually off last week. They won 34-21 over Campbellsville in Mitchell Stadium. The win was the Tigers was over BU's first in the series, as Campbellsville had won the three previous meetings dating back to 2012. We mentioned the Cats averaging 64 points a game, number one in the country, and Bluefield averaging 42, so both are high-scoring offenses. I will tell you this, at Bluefield, right off the bat, they really like to throw it. They are yielding 34 points a game, They're 11th in the nation in scoring, and they're only rushing the ball 88 yards a game, 326 in the air. Compare that to Bethel, and Bethel's averaging 200 on the ground and 243 in the air. Bethel averaging, giving up just 6.5 points a game. Jeremy McCulley, on paper, it looks like all Bethel, but you don't play the games on paper, do you?
No, you do not, and I appreciate you having me on air today. I tell you, it's a beautiful day for football, and looking forward to it. I'm not sure we could predict better weather for today. Diamond Dave, Diamond Dad, not sure what I should call you, but excited about this afternoon.
Either one will be fine. Dewey Lusk is the head mentor. And we mentioned, if you're just joining us, Dino Kakalis, former head coach here at Bethel. He is the defensive coordinator and associate head coach at Bluefield. I want to say a big hello to Nicole back on Bluefield listening and watching. And meanwhile, Gabby and Bella. Bella had some softball duties today, so they could not make the trip. But those girls have really grown up, and thank goodness they look just like their mother. 64 points a game versus 42, so you get the drift. It should be a high-scoring affair today. Coming in the ball game, the Rams are giving up 221 on the ground, 304 in the air. They're yielding 575 yards per game. Bethel coming in at 201.5. The Cats, we mentioned last week, just outstanding. They led Jeremy 42-0 at the end of the first quarter. They led 63-0 at halftime. And I looked over at Derek Hubble to my right, to your right as well, and I said, Hub, I wish we had the high school rule here. And thank goodness the coaches did agree just to play 10-minute quarters in the third and fourth quarter. Bethel, you've got the rank there. They're number seven. And meanwhile, you look down here, and there's Georgetown and Lindsey Wilson, both ranked from the conference as well.
Yeah, it's just talking earlier this morning about our last trip to Lindsey Wilson. I believe that's the last time I've been on the air with you. And I believe that was 2 to 3 years ago. And being here at the stadium here in McKenzie, it reminds me a lot of the Lindsey Wilson Stadium. And it's amazing what Bethel's transformed this place to be over the past few years since I've gotten back to town.
Yeah, you marvel when we drove up this morning. You're my chauffeur, my Uber driver this morning. You marvel at how beautiful the campus is with the new buildings and, of course, the football stadium. It is absolutely great. A lot of flavor here. The Rams brought their tents today, the blue and red and white. Bethel has the purple and gold tents right below us as well, trying to keep a little of the weather off of them a little bit. It's sunny, partly cloudy, more or less sunny than it is partly cloudy, to be honest with you, and temperatures in the low 80s when this game begins. We mentioned the Rams coming in here today. Other action today, Reinhardt's at Cumberland's, Kentucky. That's going to be a great battle there. Cumberland's is undefeated. Faulkner's at Pikeville. Bluefield here at Bethel. Point at Lindsey Wilson, and Kentucky Christian's at Cumberland, Tennessee. Next week, Point, they're at Lindsey Wilson. And then next week, they'll be here. We'll have airtime for you 12:30, and 1 o'clock will be the kick. Executive producer and director of our telecast today is Paul Schulte. The director is Christopher Reasons. The replay director today is our lovely buddy, Ashley Janda. Meanwhile, Eric Inman is on the cameras. Olivia Barlow, our lovely friend too, is down on the field. And Paul Schulte will actually be in the end zone. I'm not sure if I can see down there yet if he's in the bucket truck, but he's going to be trying to get up in the bucket truck to film from the end zone as well. So that's going to be an added addition to all the angles that you'll see here today with Worthy Road Studios and, of course, the Ball Game Blitz, and we'll tell you more about them. They not only do Bethel, but they do USJ, Jackson Christian, TCA, Union University, and the Rockabilly's baseball team over in Jackson as well. So we're really glad to have them aboard. And, of course, our long, steady folks with us through the media through the years, Tom Yarborough and Brandon, all the gang at WEIO 100.1. So today, if we overbroadcast, you think you're watching the game, you think, well, wait a minute, we're watching the game. You don't have to be so graphic. Well, we do have a radio audience. We remind you of that as well. This is the countdown to kickoff. We'll take another two-minute break, and when we come back, we'll tell you more about the teams, we'll tell you about the officials, we'll give you the starting lineups, and we'll tell you more about the Cats and the Rams when we come back after this two-minute message on the countdown to kickoff on the Bethel Football Network.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit,
call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
All those buttons. There we go. Get all the buttons straightened out there. But we do apologize. A little technical. We have some new equipment that we're working with this year, so we're trying to get all that straightened out. And Tom Yarbrough says everything is okay on his end. Nicole Cackle is just checking in with us and says, wanted to check on us, make sure your phone stuff's good. I see the stream looks great. So we'll make sure now that we have the audio and make sure. I'll check with Christopher Reasons, our producer director. Chris, everything coming audio-wise okay? Good. All right. Chris tells me everything's okay. So Gabby and Bella back busy today back in Bluefield, and Nicole couldn't make the trip. We wish you could have done that. Love to have seen them, but certainly we appreciate them tuned in up in Bluefield. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. We'll first of all start with Bethel. On the defensive side of the ball, the tackles will be Jamal Goldburn along with Christian Cantrell. The nose guard will be Xavier King. We'll tell you more about each one of these players as we get into the game and the broadcast itself. Darian Burns, who had the big return for the touchdown last week, one of four pick sixes that Bethel's had this year on the season. Darian Burns is a linebacker. The other linebacker is Darian Lewis, a really good group of linebackers. Brody Franks gets the start today. He'll start at the linebacker as well. The rover will be Brian Hughes. The nickel is Jalen Beasley. The corners will be Demetrius Gilbert, who's just an outstanding athlete, and Cortez Eatman right there as well. Safety is Jaron Rainey. So a really good sound defensive squad for the Cats, who's only yielding 6.5 points per game. The offensive, one change on the offensive side of it, Wynn will not start at left guard. It will be Kadeem Chavez who will start there today. Jackson Surratt will be the left tackle. The center will be Jaden Taylor. The right guard is Dylan Morales. The right tackle is Logan Davis. Wide receiver, Jalen Taylor. Tight end will be Tyrell Partee. Meanwhile, the wide receiver is Avant Burris. J.D. Dixon, the All-American, already is a sophomore, the all-time leader in yardage as a receiver for Bethel, and that's phenomenal. He is a phenomenal athlete as well. Talked to J.D. in the calf the other day. He is a great wide receiver. The running back, Martez Smith, who used to be at Cumberland's, he comes in here today. Smith has really had a fine debut for the Cats. Coming in the game today, 11 carries, 74 yards, and his longest is only 16, but he's got a touchdown, and he's really played well, averaging 6.7 yards per carry as well. The quarterback will be Joaquin Collazo III. Collazo, the lefty, just an outstanding player. Two rushing touchdowns thus far. The transfer from Tusculum University, 21 of 35 in the air, 60%, 370 yards, a touchdown, and he has just been one of the great. Last year, 29 touchdown passes, which is second best in program history, I might add. Meanwhile, the defensive side, we mentioned them, and the offensive side, let's take a look at the special teams players for Bethel. Braden Johnson, who's averaging 50 yards per punt, is the punter. The kicker is Andrew Welch. Welch has only missed one PAT all year. Looking down at my stat sheet, I can't remember all these things, folks. We have to cheat a little bit. He's 17 of 18 in PATs. And the long snapper is Graham Lyle. The punt snapper is Graham Lyle. The holder is Braden Johnson. The punt returner, Gilbert and Taylor. And on the kickoff returns, it's Gilbert and Eatman. For the youngsters from Bluefield, the wide receiver, Thomas Lee. Other wide receiver, Nate Monroe. Left tackle, Tremaine Baker. Left guard, Anthony Murray. Center is C.J. Price. Jahari Riley's the right guard. The right tackle is Eli Morgan. The quarterback, really a good one, Nathan Herstick. The running back is Cadence Lamp. The wide receiver, Jules Gray. And the other wide receiver is Cage Chambers. Defensively, they'll have Robertson and Griffin the ends. The nose will be Barnes. The linebackers, Bo Nadala, one of my favorite names. Jack Everidge is the other linebacker, along with Logan Patron. Defensive secondary, Padgett, Wilson, Finnessy, Banks, and Wolf. So that's a look at the offense and defensive side for the Rams as well. New scoreboard. They've got all the commercials up there, all the folks that make it possible for us to be here today and for you to be here as well. The color guard is from here, the ROTC, the Bethel ROTC color guard will present the colors today. Let's take a two-minute break. We'll come back as they do that. And we'll have the coin toss, the starting lineups we just gave you, the coin toss, and the kickoff. It's all coming up right after this on the Bethel Football Network.
First Move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntingdon. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit, call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Wildcat Stadium, your national anthem. Under the direction of Dr. Derek Jones, the Renaissance Band with your national anthem. Welcome back to Wildcat Stadium, everybody. Great job by Dr. D. He and I were in Lambeth together for a long time, and he was way up in Kentucky. Now he's been at Bethel here for a few years and has done a great job. Nicole said that Bella's team won the first softball game. They're about to play another one. So we appreciate, again, Nicole and Gabby and Bella and all the gang. They're watching Dad today as Dino has come home, and we're glad to have Dino. I had a little photo op that we'll put on our Facebook page a little later of me and Dino and Mike Jasper. And I'm not a real big guy, but, man, I look really small in that picture with Mike and Dino, didn't I? I mean, they're football guys, aren't they, Jeremy?
Yeah, you do. Of course, if I were in that picture, I would look much smaller than you did. So I was glad I wasn't in it.
And as much as I love that photo op, one coming up later at halftime. Coach Chris Nelson is going to be our halftime guest, by the way, and talk a little Lady Cat basketball. Former assistant to me, former assistant to Chris Nelson, and now the head tennis coach here, the two most important people in this box, Claire Craddock and Derek Hubble. The officials making their way to midfield. Let's tell you who those officials are. The referee will be G. Adam Stimmel. The umpire is Nathan Harris. Headline judge, Josh Underwood. Line judge, Michelle Single. Side Judge Corey Calloway, Field Judge Kyle Pearson, Bat Judge Jeremy Bank, or Beck, I should say. Game clock operator today is always here with us every Saturday, Barry Capps, and the play clock operator, a guy that took all of his training from Derek Hubble, Adam Welch, in the box as well. So the Renaissance Band has formed a quarter out there with the cheerleaders. I pick on him a lot, don't I, Claire? He loves it. And the official is getting ready to welcome out the Cats. Always fun, Jeremy. You'll see the fireworks aren't here today, are they, Hub? I don't see the fireworks folks here today. We'll have them maybe down the road. And 82 degrees. Claire was only off 1 degree as the Cats get ready to come out here and take on the Rams. Let's tell you about the coaching staff. We mentioned Dino a lot. How about Michael Jasper, the head coach, fifth year? Mike comes in here today and 27 wins already. He's done a really good job and sort of turned this thing around a little bit after Coach Dierman was here, did a great job. And then Mike has followed him and done a really super job as well coming in here today with the Cats. Chris Springer, he's been with Mike for a few years. He's the defensive coordinator and associate head coach. The other associate head coach is Jay Bright, who's the offensive guru. He's the coordinator there. Dustin Kincaid, a former Wildcat player himself, special teams coordinator, linebacker coach. And he sort of keeps us straight with the SID department as well. He feeds us a lot of information. Terrell Jackson, the senior defensive analyst. Brett Peterson, Brett still needs a haircut. Halfbacks and tight end coach. Troy Brewer is the defensive line coach. MD Daniels. These guys are basically student assistants, but they're assistant coaches as well. Pass game coordinator. Kyle Wallace, defensive backs. Jamel Warren, linebacker assistant. Bryce Missy, the newcomer, running backs. Davius Prather, one of the great players of all time here. He's an offensive assistant, works with the wide receivers as well. Kobe Johnson, offensive assistant, newcomer at quarterbacks. Kyle Parker, talked to Kyle this morning. He was telling me how tired he was. I said, man, you're not even a third of my age. Offensive line assistant. A.B. Holloway is the defensive assistant. Caleb Hall, special teams assistant. And Carrie Stahl, a new addition to the coaching staff. She's actually a student here, but she works with them with a marketing content director as well. Well, the Cats waiting a little bit here before they come out. We haven't seen the captains of the Cats yet. We look across the way, Jeremy, and I see number 8. The surgery paid off. Kadarius Finisi also will be Tyrese Wolf. He is a defensive back. Also will be number 12, Quincy Robertson, defensive lineman. Not real big for a defensive lineman, Robertson, but I'm sure he's pretty quick. 6'3", doesn't look too 40 up here, but he is. And meanwhile, the other captain, if you'll turn this way, there he is. It is Logan Patron, offensive linebacker, outside linebacker, a senior from Smithfield, Virginia. This team coming in, averaging 42, yielding 34. They're 2-0. This is their first road game of the year. Coming in, averaging 88 on the ground, 326 in the air. And it will be Bluefield today wearing the white, the road white today, with the red numbers. Their scheme is pretty well red, white, and blue. We're getting all sorts of messages from folks saying, go Cats. And I'm not sure who that is. We'll go back and see who that is. Watching from somewhere around the country. But great to have with us again, Worthy Road Studios, the captains, Collazo. Cats will wear the all-black today. Collazo, wearing number 13 on your screen there. Also number 4 will be Darian Burns, returned the pick 6 last week. I was kidding. He was teasing me, Jeremy, because he got to about the 40. He picked it off down at about the 35 to our left. He got to about the 40, and I said, he's going to score if he doesn't run out of gas. He went back and watched the replay, and he said, I almost did, Mr. McCulley. Yeah, but really one of the more colorful characters on this team. Also will be Xavier King, the nose, and number 67, the big guy. If I was built like Jackson Surratt, I'd be dangerous, Jeremy McCulley. He's the big guy, an offensive lineman, Surratt, 6'2", 318 from Boaz, Alabama. Your thoughts about the game? Cats coming in heavy favorite.
Well, you know, looking at both teams, I mean, I don't get a chance to do many of these games with you, but both teams seem to have a lot of size. And the one good thing is we've got one team in all white, one team in all black, so it's not going to be too hard to be distinguished on who's who this afternoon, and which would be great. But the size, I watch a lot of different teams on football. I don't get a chance to announce this kind of stuff like you do, Dom and Dave. But the size is, I don't know, it's appealing to me. Like, it's definitely noticeable.
Yeah, they're pretty big, no doubt. And Bluefield's pretty big, but Bethel has got a monstrous group of linemen. That hello was from our own good buddy, Craig Lund, who couldn't be with us today. Craig did an outstanding job last week on color, and you've got some big shoes to fill. He's not only a voice of the McKenzie Rebels, but he's our new color analyst this year. He did a great job. It's almost like we had worked together for years, and that was our first time to work together last week. But Craig is on official school duty today. He's an employee of the school, and he's up in Murfreesboro doing some duties that he gets paid a lot more to do those than he does this, by the way, but you do get paid. But We're getting ready for this one, and a little bit of delay here. Let's see. It's 12:57, so we're still about 3 minutes before the official kickoff. As far as Hubble's concerned, we can go ahead and kick it off right now. The Cats down in that north end zone. You get a great look at the captains. And, boy, I tell you, the graphics and the video coverage by Worthy Road Studios, Jeremy, it's like CBS is here, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is. You know, I'm trying to channel in my inner Kirk Herbstreit here, you know, pretending it's CBS, but it is a big deal. They're doing a great job looking at over at the monitor right now. One of the things that I asked you about earlier today was I was like, oh, my vision's not so great, and you said just wait until you see the monitor. Looking over at the monitor, it really is first class.
Yeah, you can see great here from our press box. We're up, what are we, Hubble, three stories up here at the press box, I guess it would be, but or two stories up. But anyway, you look at this monitor, boy, and listen, you don't even have to watch things down the field. You can just watch this. Remind you folks, too, that's watching the game that we do have a radio audience, so if we over-describe, that's the reason that we're doing that. Well, the officials about to meet the captains. You see the Cats strolling out there, 2-0 on the season. Number 7 in the country. And this football team has got some high expectations. The coaching staff was a little disappointed. They weren't ranked in the top 5 to begin the season. They were number 4 last year, 11-1. Became the first team in school history to win 11 games during the regular season and go undefeated until they got to the playoffs, and then were beaten by Kaiser, who went on to the national title game, I might add. You see down there Olivia Barlow. Now, that's a great shot by Olivia. See her down there, Jeremy, right on the cat. She's getting that great shot of the officials and the captains. We'll wait and see what the official tells us, Mr. Stimmel, and who's going to win the toss and what they elect to do when they win it or lose it. And the toss is in the air, and let's see what's going to happen here. Bethel's won the toss. They have won the toss, and they have elected to – I couldn't tell. He didn't make it real point blank with us. We'll have to talk to Mr. Stimmel about that. Now he's going to tell us. So Bethel has won the toss. And Hubble, did they elect to receive? He hadn't told us yet, has he?
It's hard to tell at this point.
Yep, Bethel won the toss, and they'll have the ball to begin this football game. Again, that offensive unit, Cantrell, King, Goburn, Burns. That's your defensive side of the ball. We'll see them a little later, Diamond Dave. Frank's there at linebacker as well. The left tackle, Surratt. The left guard, Wynn. The center, Taylor. Right guard, Morales. Right tackle, Davis. And, Jeremy, if you look at those weights, I mean, you can go through the list there and see. 67, Surratt, we mentioned. He is now 318. Left guard, Wynn. Wynn is right at 316. Center, Taylor. He is 290. The right guard, Morales, he's the run of the bunch at 260. And the right tackle, Davis, 265. So they're averaging, with those guys falling off a little bit there at the end, they're averaging about 285, 290 along that front line.
Yeah, the combination has like a line of steel dominate.
Cats run the house, wearing the black, white helmets. I always love this black, all black, because you can see the numbers so well. Well, to kick it away for the Rams will be Riley Stubbs, a 5'11", 165 junior. And the Cats will send back on the kickoff return. They'll send back, unless they change something drastically here on me, Gilbert and Eatman. Gilbert, Jeremy, wait till you see him. You haven't seen Bethel play this year, but he is absolutely a superstar. He's had a kickoff return or a punt return for a touchdown, and he is a great, great receiver as well. Well, they're getting the band off the field. And Dr. Jones getting them off the field. It's hot down there, guys. Give them a break now. They got all their gear on, too. Hubble's a tough cookie, isn't he? He's tough on everybody.
Yeah, he is.
He's tough on me.
He is a tough cookie. I feel like we could put him down there on the line. Looking down at Coach Jasper, though, I mean, his weight and his size at this point.
One of his less glorious moments in life was on this field in a PE class.
Okay.
That I happened to be
at. I'd love to hear more about it.
Dr. Knieva, I'll tell you on the way home.
Yeah.
Well, the kick it away will be – actually, Bandy's going to kick it away. 41's going to kick it. So Isaiah Bandy will kick it away. We don't have him in our system either. Here's Gilbert. He'll gather it in at about the 12. Far side left to the 15 to the 20. Great downfield kickoff return coverage. And, boy, I mean, there was about three or four guys that swamped him down there. And Gilbert took it about the 12. And, Jeremy, he only got about to the 18, only a six-yard return.
It was pretty flooded
Bandy.
Down there.
Isaiah Bandy's his name. We're helping our stat crew out. B-A-N-D-Y, Bandy, a freshman. B-A-N-D-Y, yes. So the Cats will have it. They'll begin the first play from scrimmage of this football game. They'll have it at their own 18-yard line. The nose of the ball right at the 18. The quarterback will be Galazzo. Smith will be the – it was Gilbert, number two, that caught it and brought it back only 6 yards. Gilbert. And here they go with the jet sweep to Dixon. Dixon's hit in the backfield and dropped for about a 3 yard loss back to the 15. Outstanding play. The first guy there was number 17. That's Bowden Nadali. Nadali got him really quickly, and that didn't fool anybody on the jet sweep here to the near side. A loss of three back to the 15. It's going to be second down and 13. Not a good start there offensively, Jeremy.
No, it wasn't, and he got tripped up just a hair there, but hopefully he can keep his feet grounded a little bit more.
Smith was in the pistol. Now he moves up. They put Burris in motion. Colazo looks over the middle, still looking, and it's caught. The defender fell down. That ball is caught this time by Taylor. Taylor's up across the 35 to the 40 at a first down. First down for the Cats. They move to the 40-yard line. A big pickup of 25 yards on that play as the defender fell down.
Great little double take to the left, took it to the right.
Colazo in that gun again, Smith to his right. Colazo looks, wants to pass. Throws it out in the flat, wide open, caught this time by Burris. Burris, the second leading receiver on the team, is inside the 40 and knocked out of bounds across the way. He's inside the Bluefield 40 and knocked out of bounds by Tyrese Wolf. So the ball at the 39. Well, that's another big pickup. Colazo picking them apart. Jeremy had 29 touchdown passes last year, the most in a single season in Bethel history.
That's very impressive.
Been some great quarterbacks here through the years as well. Colazo, play fakes, throws it out to Dixon. Dixon trying to get a block from Burris, gets one. He's at the 30, 25, the magic man inside the 20, all the way down to about the 16, 15-yard line. Already, Jeremy McCulley, number 37, your first look at him, J.D. Dixon. Dixon, the young man from, well, not far from here. He is from Waverly, Tennessee, Waverly Central, all-time leader in passing yardage in a career here, already just a sophomore. Play fake, they go the slant in pattern, Dixon, touchdown Cats! They score at the 13-12 mark. Well, the running attack didn't hurt them on the first play, but three straight passes, all big ones, and from 25 yards out, the touchdown to Dixon. That, ladies and gentlemen, an 82-yard drive, and Dixon goes in. On Dixon's credit, that is his second touchdown of the year reception. Colazo, that is his, ladies and gentlemen, second. We'll make it more than that. We'll double-check that. And Johnson in to attempt the PAT. Here's the kick. Or make it Welch. Excuse me. He's only missed one, and he missed that one. He hit the right crossbar, so it remains a 6-0 game. Well, the 82-yard drive, the Cats are on the board at the 13-10 mark. Back after this, 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
Well, the Cats, just like last week, get on the board really quick. At the 13-10 mark, a 15-yard pass, Derek Hubble tells me, 82-yard drive. The PAT by Welch was no good. That's only his second miss coming in here. He's now 17 of 19 on the year. So it remains 6-0. Here's Johnson. He does the kickoff. Had several touchbacks last week. He's got another one. That's his seventh of the year. Knocks it through the eye of the Wildcats back there. And that will bring out Bluefield, the Rams on offense, Jeremy, after an impressive drive by Bethel.
Yeah, it was 2 minutes, 50 seconds for the first score there, so it was pretty quick, exciting to see.
82-yard drive, and Hubble corrected me on that 15-yard pass play.
Yes, he did.
Well, coming out now will be the quarterback. That's going to be Nathan Herstritt, and he'll be in the shotgun with his running back to his right. That running back will be Cardius Gilmore. Two wide outs, far side right. They hand it off. Gilmore crunches his way for a couple of yards. May get three out of that. He'll move to about the 27, almost, yep, 2 yards. Gilmore carried it. Gilmore, young man from Bedford, Virginia, Liberty High School. That's his 17th carry of the year, so he's at 79 yards on the year. He goes out of the game. They bring a new player in there. And that quarterback again, Nathan Herstick, 5'11", 180, redshirt junior out of St. Cloud, Florida. Came in here today with 653 yards passing. Drops back in the pocket. Now will be flushed out. He's going to run the ball. He's at the 30 and will be hit hard there. Be short of the first down and closing the gap real quickly was Jaron Rainey, the defensive back, Jeremy. Rainey number six, yes. No, he's number five, Rainey is. Hurst loves to pass it. Jeremy, we mentioned a moment ago, right before that snap, 45 of 68, 653 yards, rushing touchdown, has a couple passing touchdowns as well. Five touchdowns, as a matter of fact. So it's third down and four, a good four, from just around the 31-yard line. In that gun with a back to his right. Drops back, looks, throws out here to flat, and missed his receiver. He was open and probably would have had the first down. Jules Gray, the wide receiver, the junior, could not come up with it. So it's three up, three down, and the Cats are getting the balls back on it. So the offense scores, the defense holds.
Yeah, that was a great stop. It was pretty
He was open, though, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was open, you know, and the quarterback there had a chance. And I tell you, he's standing at 5'10". He looks a little smaller than 5'10" out there on the field.
Well, a kid last week, O'Banks, he was about 5'7". He couldn't see over the line. He fought hard. He ran the ball well, but he really had trouble seeing over the Bethel's defensive line.
Yeah, that's the quarterback running gun we see these days.
Well, the very talented Gilbert stands back around his 40-yard line. The punter out there will be Stubbs. Let's make sure that's right. They changed up on the kicker a moment ago. Here's the punt. And not a great punt. A short punt.
Knocker.
And we'll take a roll, and now we'll be down around the 49-yard line. Bethel's going to come out of that with great field position. As that time, it was, again, Bandy punting the ball as well. So we apologize. Not following the two deep here. I'll just watch the numbers there. They might have changed things up. We had a couple of changes late as well. Bob Redd, the SID over at Bluefield, does a great job over there. We appreciate Bob. He and I have worked well together in years past. Haven't played this bunch a lot. First time since 2019. Well, the ball actually is the 49-yard line of the Rams. So it's first and 10 there for Galazzo. Well, you give him a short field, he can really burn you. That defensive front, three down linemen. You folks listening can trust me. Folks watching can see it on the screen there. Galazzo hands off Smith. Smith, 45. Smith on his feet, stumbles his way to about the 42. Jeremy, a transfer, University of the Cumberland, had almost 300 yards against us a few years ago when he came in here. Came in here today with running the ball well, with averaging 6.7 yards per carry, and he got about 8 that time.
It looks like he's going to get about 6.7 to 8 every run he's got, looking at Bluefield's offense, unless they step something up a little bit. But
second down and a short two, the ball near the 41-yard line. Receiver stacked right here below us, right in front of you. Here's Colazo. Colazo will throw it. It's going to be caught by Burris at the 25 to the 20. Burris is out of bounds at about the 21-yard line. He's going to be actually knocked out about the 19. The Cats just tearing him apart right now. That pop pass to number 7, Burris. We're having our strat crew out here. He's inside the 20 to the 19. And now whistles shrill throughout the afternoon air here. And there's a marker on the play from across the way.
This game could transform a little bit, but at the rate we're going, this looks a little easy for the Bethel Wildcats.
Claire, if you need to get someone else to help spot, we can do that. But is it their lineup? Is that what it is? All right. That ball will be marked back to the 23-yard line. Not sure what they call there, but a 5-yard infraction. And the ball will be at the 23-yard line. It's going to be first and 15. Here's Colazzo in the gun with double far side left. Here's Smith to the left of Colazzo. Colazzo will stop, drop back, and popped in the backfield and down for a loss. Going to be a sack there. We'll see who got that. He'll scramble his way back to about the 26. So now it's going to be third down, Jeremy, in about almost 17 yards. Let's call it a good 16 anyway.
Yeah, this is the toughest defeat Bethel's had at this point. We'll see what they do here. But
they mark the 26, and they got to get down to about the 8. So second down at almost 15 yards, a good 14. Doubles far side left this time, top of your screen. Receivers here to the bottom. Here's Collazo dropping back. Collazo looking. He's got a man wide open.
Wow.
Caught by Dixon. Wow. Overled him a little bit, but Dixon, you get it near him, and Dixon will catch it. And from 26 yards out, it is, again, the second time today, Collazo has caught Dixon 15 yards earlier, 26 yards here. And the Cats will send out Welch to attempt the PAT, leading the game 12-0. And Jeremy, great throw, but a phenomenal catch by Dixon.
It was a phenomenal catch. I mean, he was going away, and I mean, you know, he had to get up there. But I tell you, that right there is impressive. I mean, 3rd and 17 coming down. I mean, it's very impressive. I mean, so Bethel's off to a great start here.
Johnson the holder, and it will be Welch to attempt the PAT. This one is true, and it's 13-0 Cats. We'll take a 30-second break. Be back with the Cats back on defense after this on the Bethel Football Network.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Celebrate a repeat of last week when Bethel led 42-0 at the first in the first quarter. I'm not sure that's going to happen here. This is a much better Bluefield team, but right now Collazo and Dixon have teamed up for two touchdown passes. Jeremy, a 49-yard drive following an 82-yard drive, and the Cats lead the game 13-0.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive, the start that Bethel's off to right now. I mean, they just kind of look unstoppable, in my opinion.
Wolf elects to let that go in the end zone, the kick, second touchback of the game for Johnson. Johnson, a newcomer on this team, and really has developed into a really good kicker. Handles the kickoffs. Welch does the PATs and the field goes. Johnson's got a strong leg as well. And he knocked that through again the end zone. And Wolf very wisely let it go in the back of the end zone.
Diamond Dave, that kick was good back. I see 13-0 on the scoreboard.
Yeah, the PAT, yes,
yeah,
was.
Yeah, the PAT was good.
Yeah, Welch.
Clarifying to Derek Hubble over here.
35, Welch had it. Here's Hurstick, the quarterback. Will pass outside lateral, actually, and now that dual trick play, and they've got the guy open at the 45-yard line to the 48. Nice play. Halfback pass that time. And Monroe caught that ball, and he's up
and
near
you,
midfield at the 48-yard line. A big pickup there, Jeremy.
Out of everything, Bluefield needed a little pick-me-up there.
A little mojo, a little hanky-panky, wasn't
absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. So they needed that.
Hurstick brings them back up. First and 10, that's a 23-yard pickup. Handoff, and carrying it will be Gilmore. And Gilmore crashes his way toward midfield. We'll be down there. You see a great shot there. The Cats, Xavier King and Brody Franks in the stop. King coming in the game today. A sack and a fumble. Brody Franks, 9 tackles, now make it 10 on the year. Dropping back, Hurstick looks. Being flushed out, it's going to be sacked. As they they did not get back to the line of scrimmage. About a yard short of it, so a sack. And that sack by Timothy Hamilton, that's his second sack of the year, Jeremy. And the Cat defense stayed at home, didn't it?
Yeah, Hurstis looks quick.
Here's a replay of it.
His size, with Bethel's, defensive line, he's not going to get too far considering how quick he looks today.
Christopher Reasons with a great replay there. Hamilton trailing the play a little bit, dragged him down. Double clutch. Now they go to the outlet pass. It's caught out there at midfield. He makes one guy miss, makes the second guy miss, but the third guy can't make him miss. And Gilmore has it down inside the Bethel 46 to about the 45. And he'll be down there. Do we have a flag on the play? Maybe it was a sideline warning. I couldn't tell what was happening there. The official motioned something to the white hat. So at the 45-yard line, the quarterback was sacked by 94. It's right. Sideline warning first on Bethel, so no penalty there. Let's see if they send out the punter. I think they are. Bandy's going to come out and punt the ball. Gilbert will stand back inside his 20, and Bandy will kick it, punt it away from about his own 40. Under 8 minutes now. The Cats lead already 13-0. Highest scoring team in the country, and they look like it right now. Boy, Bluefield needs a defensive stop this time, not again a great punt. They're trying to keep it away from Gilbert, no doubt about that, Jeremy, but what's happening, he shanked it twice off the side of his foot.
Yeah, which is not a good indication on their how confident they are where they're punting the ball. And I mean,
and the first guy that met him over there, I've got a good look at him, the special teams coach. Not real happy with Bandy. Bandy did what I would do. He ran away from him. The ball will be at the 27, first and 10 there for the Cats. They're on 27. Glad you're with us this afternoon. The game being brought to you by Trevathan's, Citizens Bank and Trust, or Carroll Bank and Trust, I should say, Anchor Transportation, Nikki Joe Stafford, Smith & Smith Optometry. We'll tell you more about our great corporate sponsors in a minute. Colossal will move Smith to his right. Puts a man in motion, Dixon here. They give it to Dixon. Dixon trying. Now Dixon's going to throw it back to Colazo. Now Colazo is going to try to throw it downfield, and it's going to be incomplete.
Ooh.
And incomplete that time by Taylor. And I'll tell you one thing, no matter who you pull for, what has got the ire of the crowd, Jeremy, watch this replay.
Just a little overthrown there. Watch. It kind of looked like a little defensive.
They think it was holding, yeah.
Yeah, a little defensive holding there.
Grab his jersey.
Like.
Watch this.
Yeah, no, exactly what I was about to say.
Dixon to Colazo. Now, Colazo will throw it, and watch this.
Oh, he had his jersey. He was holding him right there. He's holding
sure
right there.
Sure was.
I mean, if you have to replay that, you're going to – you. There's a flag down, so we'll see what happens. But
now, the flag is going to be back here at about the 20-yard line, though. It could be holding on
Bethel. That's got to be a plus 15.
Or in this case, minus 15. Oh, they'd be half the distance to go for Bethel.
It was so obvious, like, in the other direction. We weren't looking the opposite direction where Bethel was. So
illegal forward pass.
Wow. I didn't see where he threw that above the line of scrimmage, but well, I guess you know.
Didn't see that either. But the coaching staff not real happy with the call.
I can understand why.
So it's going to be second down now. In 15, make some receivers some adjustments here. Burris comes in the game. Couldn't tell who came out. So it's two receivers here to the near side. You see a great shot of Colazo there with Smith and the pistol right behind him. Great camera angles by our folks from Worthy Road Studios and the BallGame Blitz. Colazo will take it back there. He's going to look downfield. He's going to try to find Dixon over here, incomplete. Even as talented as Dixon is, he couldn't catch that. So it's third and 15. Well, if Bluefield ever needed a defensive stop, they need one now. Dino Kaklis, the defensive coordinator. Great coach, great guy, great family. And they'll ring up the third and 15, see what they call here. The Cats on third down conversions this year, right at 38%. Actually, 47%. I was looking at the wrong chart. That's pretty good, 47%. Colazo again in that gun. Smith moves up to his left, stays in there to block. Colazo looks out here to Dixon. Dixon one-on-one trying to make the guy miss, and he makes the
broken
guy miss.
Tackle.
30, 35, 40, midfield, 45. Boy, I'll tell you what, that's a nightmare for the coaching staff across the way. When you see Dixon one-on-one, you just knew he was going to make that guy miss. Almost got a face mask as well. Now Coach Jasper and some of the folks down there looking at Dixon, training staff rushing in as well. He may have got poked to the eye inadvertently.
It sure looks like it.
Dixon, unbelievable as a sophomore, the all-time leading pass receiver in yardage here in this history. There's a great replay of it. The coaching staff running up here, they thought it was a infraction as well. But no flag. Bethel will have the ball after all of that. Personal foul. Well, they did get the face mask. It is Wolf. So that's a big gain, Jeremy, up over midfield, and now they'll mark it off. And that's going to mark the ball inside the 30. That's exactly what Dino and the Bluefield coach Lusk did not want.
A little plus 15 there.
Down the 28-yard line. So they move the ball, Bethel has from the 27 to the 28 of Bluefield. Clock running, 7 minutes left in the first. Smith to the left of Colazo. He puts Burris in motion. Little flip here, and here's the jet sweep the other way to Burris. Burris trying to make someone miss, doesn't. Well, he made a first guy, I guess, miss. And in on the tackle was Quincy Robertson, their leading tackler from Wilmington, North Carolina. Good play there by him, or Burris would have had more. And Burris really quick. We brag about the athleticism of Dixon. Burris pretty quick too, isn't he?
Yeah, extremely quick. I mean, it's
Burris from Nashville went to Hillsboro. Second down and six, a good six after the 3.5-yard pickup. Palazzo, Smith this time. Smith, big hole. 20, 15, comes outside to the 10.
He's in.
He's to the 5. Ooh. And finally, the touchdown saving tackle by Finnessy. And Smith tumbles his way to the 5. It's going to be first and goal for Bethel.
Bethel looks pretty tough to stop right now.
I'm telling you, the whole package, buddy.
Yeah.
The whole package.
Right now, it appears to be that way. It's
6 minutes left, now under 6. At the 5, it's first and 10. Collazo. See if Smith gets the handoff this time. Collazo gives it Smith. Smith trying to go far side left, and a great tackle there. Outstanding tackle by Elijah Paget, their fourth leading tackler from Princeton, West Virginia. And that's a loss of almost 2 yards, second and goal from the 7. In the ball game for the Cats, Tyrell Partee, backup tight end, coming out. Well, actually, just go tight end there. They bring Burris, receiver, out. Going to the power crunch offense this time. So the ball at the 7, second and goal there. 13-0 Bethel already. 82 degrees, pretty hot down on the field. Nice up here. Collazo gives it Smith. Smith trying to find a hole. Doesn't find much, one at all. Helmet's flying off. Logan Patron, number 4, the first guy there. The guy that lost the helmet was Bowden Nadali. There's some athleticism on this defensive side of the ball. Bethel has a big weight advantage on them on the line. There's a replay, Jeremy.
Yeah, Blue Ridge has definitely stepped up on this side, on their defensive side, to show a little bit of what they can handle.
Big plays. I want to go Bethel in the red zone this year. Phenomenal thus far. They were 11 of 12 with touchdowns, and the other was a field goal. Here's the run by Collazo, turning the corner 5, and he's going to dance in the end zone. I think he's in. It is his. Collazo, his third rushing touchdown of the year. The pass taken away from him, so he went far side left and barely creeps in, Jeremy McCullough.
I tell you, man, the lefty running in there reminds me of the old Tim Tebow. And
here's a good look at it.
Yeah, and that's impressive. I mean, the Bethel offense is—it's pretty apparent they're unstoppable right now. So Bluefield's really got their work cut out for him, unless they want to stop this, you know, moving forward.
Here is the snap by Lyle Johnson, the holder. Welch high snap, but Welch pulls it in. Or excuse me, Johnson pulls it in and Welch knocks it through. It's 20-0. That was a 73-yard drive capped off by the 6-yard run by Collazo. Another 30. The Cats are on the prowl here early. Stay with us on the Bethel Football Network.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntingdon. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Appreciate the nice message from Larry Giraldi, former golf coach here, former softball coach. He and Rita in the house are watching, even though they're in the house. It's 20-0. Here's the kick. Wolf's going to let it sail over his head again. Third touchback of the game for Braden Johnson. Got a strong, strong leg. Well, the Cats lead the game 20-0. They came in averaging 64, number one in the country. Unless the Bluefield folks can ring something up here really quick defensively, this game's going to get away from them. Bethel hoping that's the case. Of course, you Bluefield fans watching hope that's not the case, obviously. Well, it's going to be now. Sort of under the gun. Not necessarily, Jeremy, that they have to score down 20-0 with 4:42, but, well, they got to keep Bethel's offense off the field, don't they?
Absolutely. I mean, it's pretty dominant at this point. I mean, Bethel's offense, I mean, looking at them, I mean, they're unstoppable. So
Hurstick drops back, looks, flushed out of the pocket, being chased by 3 linemen, and going to be knocked out of bounds at about the 26.
He's flooded down there.
Yep, nowhere to go, and that's great secondary coverage there. And now a flag comes in.
I don't know if that was a late hit, unsportsmanlike conduct.
Well, the officials talking over the white hat. 19 penalties this year on the Bluefield for 190 yards. Bethel We've had our share as well. We'll sort that out for you. Here's a white hat. Mr. Stimmel tells us what's going to happen here. I think it's going to be on Bethel. Unsportsmanlike conduct on the Cats.
Yep.
Well, that will give Bethel their 15th penalty of the year, 164 yards. And Coach Jasper can't be happy, but especially Coach Chris Springer, the defensive coordinator, can't be happy because you stopped them for about a yard pickup. Now you give them a first down to the 40.
Not a penalty you want, but Bluefield, you know, gets something going here, I'm not sure how far they'll move the ball.
I think Chris showed us the replay, and I apologize we didn't see it, but not on Chris, that's on us. Bang! Boy, hit back there. Now he got the pass away. Let's see if the official said he caught it. Boy, it was a pass. Now they're going to rule it they say complete.
Wow.
To the 46-yard line.
Looked like he was on the ground there when he caught
that. What a hit by Bethel. Was that 92? I think that was that wasn't 92. Who was that got the hit? That was 22, I think it was. D. Hines.
It was a big hit.
No, that was Franks, I guess, that got that hit. I'm not sure how in the world Hershey got that away, but what a remarkable catch. Who caught the pass, Claire?
He's a tough little cookie.
Three caught it, and that's Lamp. Hand off, new running back, and that's Lamp carrying the ball. Cadence Lamp from St. Augustine, Florida. We've been there before, and it's going to be a pickup. About a yard, so it's going to be third down and almost four. Third down and four, the ball at the 46. Got to get right at midfield. Clock running, 3:20 in the first. Hersick, Craig Lund not with us today. Craig's in Murfreesboro doing some school duties. He's not nervous about this game right now because Bethel's leading 20-0, but I know he's nervous about a game at 6 tonight. Doubles each way. Hersick drops back. Looks, throws out in the flat, caught by Lamp again. Lamp trying to get the first down, and he did not get there. What a nice play coming up from the secondary. That was Gilbert with a textbook play there. He got his helmet right in the knees of the running back, or the receiver in this case. And Gilbert knocked him down short about 2 yards, actually 3 yards, knocked him out the 47. They got to get to midfield.
So, Dom and Dave, you got fourth and one, fourth, one and a half. What do you do here? Do you go for it?
Or they're going to go for it. I guess they're feeling they're down 20-0, heavy underdogs.
I think that's what you have to do here.
Yeah, I think so, too. 47-yard line, Bethel could come out with great field position. Three down linemen, fourth and three from their own 47. See if they try to draw Bethel off sides. Hershick back there. Nope, they're going to play it. Hershick looks over the middle, throws it downfield. Knocked away. Great play defensively. The receiver got behind. But then coming out of nowhere.
Threw it into three guys.
That was a great play by Cortez Eatman, the defensive back, the senior from Jasper, Alabama, and the Cats get great field position on a great defensive play by Eatman.
They do, and I mean, at this point, Bethel looks pretty dominant.
Cats jumping around there. Brian Hughes there. My goodness, 47-yard line. The Cats already lead the game 20-0 with 2:17 left. Oh, boy, you couldn't draw up a better game plan if you're a Bethel fan, could you?
You really couldn't. I mean, they look so dominant at this point. Coach Jasper looks pretty confident down there on the sidelines.
Late-arriving crowd here coming in here right now. Coach Jasper looking for career win number 28, 27-15. Collazo going back to work and spins it out here, and it's incomplete. No, it's caught.
Yeah.
Nice diving catch coming back to get that.
What a great catch.
Was Will Secker. Will from Charlotte, Tennessee, Creekwood High School, and came back and bailed his quarterback out for a 9-yard pickup. So it's second and a yard. The Cats lead the game already, 20-0. Under 2 minutes now left in this first stanza. Smith hit in the backfield, bounces off the would-be tackler, bounces off another, and gets the first down. What a nice play by Martez Smith. Jeremy, he's got good, quick feet. Coming in here, 225 from Decatur, Georgia. Transfer from the University of the Cumberlands. And going out of the game for the Rams is Banks. He lost his helmet, so he has to go out. They have to get a reserve in for him. 20-0. Bethel now with another first down. First and 10 at the 34 of the Rams. Again, you folks watching, we have a radio audience. We're trying to describe the picture of them. Here's Secker out in the flat. Secker makes a guy miss on his feet to the 20, on his feet to the 17. Out of bounds, he's hurled. And another big play by Collazo. And, boy, he's Johnny on the spot right now, isn't he?
He is. I mean, I don't want to be too hard on Bluefield, but right now it looks pretty easy for Bethel.
Yep. A lot of weapons. You concentrate so much on Dixon Dixon's not back in the game after having that face mask that went against him. Here's Collazo, Smith time. Smith looking for a hole, follows the left side of the offensive line, trying to get the block from Surratt, Wynn, and Taylor. Not much of one that time. And he's hit right. Maybe he got a yard. Let's give him, I don't know if he got that. Yeah, he got a yard to about the, well, I'm not sure. 17-yard line? Nope, no gain. Second and 10. Bethel came in this game today, Jeremy, averaging almost 7 yards every time they carry the ball.
It's pretty evident that that's the case here. I mean, I don't know what they're averaging right now, but it's got to be a little bit plus that, if not that.
Rushing touchdown, which was a fourth of the year, passing or a 12th, passing two, so they've had five touchdowns in the air this year. Here's a scrunge down as they move to about the 11. And carrying that time was Mitchell Faulkner. And Faulkner came in last week, Jeremy, in a reserve role. Didn't have any run over 10 yards, but he scored three touchdowns. And now they call a timeout. We need one as well. 7 seconds. We've got an injured player on the field for Bluefield. Let's hope, say a little prayer for him. Hope he's okay. 7 seconds in the quarter. Bethel knocking on the door again on the third and three from the 11. And it's going to be 20-0 your score. Back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
With Tom Yarbrough, the controls at the radio station, WEIO 100.9, Paul Schulze, along with Christopher Reasons, Ashley Janda, Eric Inman, and Olivia Barlow on the video side. Hi, everybody. Dave McCulley, along with Jeremy McCulley, and the Bluefield Ram is down at the moment and couldn't tell and will not try to dissect what that injury might be. But the good news is they're trying to get him up. That would be the first good sign. May have just got hit there and a little dazed. Let's hope he's all right. And he is getting up, and that is going to be one of the linemen, I think. Let's wait and see. And favoring a knee. That's going to be coming in. A good hand by the Bethel crowd. That's Kadarius Finsity, the defensive back, 5'10", 155, grad student from Chattanooga. Played at the Howard School up there. And thank goodness he is walking off. He's getting some assistance, you see there, but he is able to plant his feet in the ground. That's good news. There's a good shot of the crowd here. A late arriving crowd. I think they waited till it got maybe closer to kickoff, as it is pretty warm in those stands, you might imagine, in the bleachers. Well, it's third down and three. The ball at the 11. The Cats, red zone scoring this year. We mentioned 11 of 12 times they've scored touchdowns. The other was a field goal. They're 12 of 12 in the red zone this year. That's phenomenal. And now that ends the first quarter. We take a break, a one-minute break. We'll come back. The Cats will be knocking on the door at the other end zone, down to the north end zone when we come back. They lead the game 20-0. This is Bethel Football of the Bethel Football Network. Back after this.
The purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit.
Your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit, call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
Or Bethel Wildcat player and coach Paul Frazier going over to Arkansas State this afternoon to watch the Arkansas State football team. He's listening to us. Paul, I appreciate that. Very nice of you to do that. We appreciate it very much. A lot of folks tuning in with us and trying to tell us that they're listening. We'll try to get to some of those messages Cole Kaklis is watching as well. And Tim McBride, some of the folks here that's in the house watching and listening as well. Well, the Cats will have it. And it's going to be a little scoreboard malfunction, apparently. We'll try to get that straight now here in a second. There we go. 20 to nothing, an impressive 42 on the board last week. So, Jeremy, not quite 42, but an impressive performance here in this first stanza. Collazo will have Faulkner. Remember, Faulkner had three rushing touchdowns last week. And the big offensive line will set it down. You see on your screen, two receivers to the top side there. They put a man in motion. Now they give it to Faulkner on misdirection. Faulkner will crash his way inside the five, down near the goal line. Is he in? Let's wait and see. He's got the first down. That's the big thing. It's going to be first and goal, Cats.
I think he's on the three or the four there.
Faulkner carried it. Mitchell Faulkner. And Mitchell made the stop for Bluefield.
I mean, 20 to nothing here. I mean, it's pretty obvious. I think what's going to happen here.
Yep. Well, the Cats haven't been denied in the red zone all year. It's probably Faulkner again. He's the back that gets it in the red zone most of the time. Faulkner? No, it's Collazo going for the touchdown strike.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. And that was good. That was good defense there, too.
A 6-yard. There's a marker on the play. Did he say a marker on the play?
It looked like he may have pushed off a little bit offensively, but we'll see. I couldn't really tell.
Let's wait and see. Instead of going to the running game, which I thought they would with Faulkner, they went to Dixon. He caught it. That would have been his third touchdown reception of the day.
I didn't see any push-offs there, but.
Watch the replay there. Mr. Stimmel talking to one of his cohorts. And I think it's going to stand. I think they're going to say it's the penalty is going to be on. How far out was that, Hub? Was that 6 yards out?
Five yards out.
Third touchdown reception of the day for Dixon. Well, the Cats were saying that it was going to get to them, but we haven't been told yet. Here's Mr. Stimmel. Well, he's trying to get his mic working.
I didn't see anything there.
Illegal substitution on Bluefield. Yeah, it's a touchdown. So from 5 yards out, only 19 seconds into the quarter, Dixon and Collazo this time, they teamed up from 15, 26, and now 5. Pretty impressive.
Very impressive. I mean, as Dickie V would say, warm the bus, baby. Warm the bus.
Yep. Nicole says, I agree if you're a Bluefield fan, especially a wife of one of the coaches, Dino here. But Bethel team is really, really not only good, but they're really executing as well.
Dominating.
PAT was good. And the Cats, Mr. Welch knocks it through, and it's 27 to nothing Cats, a 30 back after this on the Bethel Football Network.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
I was asking the press box group here how far the drive. They said about 8 hours to Bluefield. I was talking about the drive on the on the score. It is about 8 hours. I know Nicole sent me a picture when they left yesterday. I talked to one of their assistants. They said they left there pretty early, got here about 5. They stayed in Jackson, by the way, last night. Here's the kick and unable to pick it up. And finally, Wolf picks it up. And Wolf is down inside the 10-yard line. Well, it's still been imploding that time for the Rams. Craig Lund says we're going to drain the swamp. You probably will, but as
about 6 p.m. we'll be able to, tell.
As Lee Corso says, not so quickly, my
not
friend.
Not so quickly, my friend. Not so
yeah.
quickly.
Ball will be at the 10-yard line. It's going to be first and 10. So, with a score of 27 to nothing, they're at pinned back deep in their own territory, they being the Rams. This is a pretty good Ram football team, too, and Bethel is just, manhandling things right now. Hand off running back, and that's carrying it, Lamp. Lamp may have got a yard or two. Chain gang across the way. We didn't mention them earlier. Thomas Sharon, great friend of mine, used to work for me. Greg Driscoll, Scott Courtright. Josh Mayo couldn't be with us today, so Steve Moore is doing that, and Miles Mayo here today as well. That's the chain gang across the way. Give them a little love. No gain. Second down and 10 at the 10. Yeah, great shot at the left hash there. This is a good quarterback, too. He's thrown for over 600 yards this year, and Bethel's just taking that away from him. Flushed out of the pocket, will run for what he can get. 15-yard line and bomb right at the 15. Great open field tackle by Eatman.
He's a good quarterback, but I tell you, he's gritty. But Bethel's defense is just, he's not letting him get anywhere early.
Well, the secondary coverage has been outstanding. You see it here. Watch. There's just no one open.
He's having a tough time.
He has no one open, so he has to just say, okay, I'm going to try to run this thing.
You can already tell he's worn out.
Third down and 5. The band performing. They'll be performing at halftime. Coach Nelson's going to join us at halftime. Here's Hersey dropping back. Out in the flat, man open, short of the first down. Great stop there by, again, that's going to be Eatman and Brian Hughes making the stop. And it looked like he might have the first down, Jeremy, and then those backs closed down on him quickly. You see the replay here. He's going to come up about 2 yards short. That's just great secondary coverage.
Yeah, I don't believe that Bluefield's had any first down conversions at this point. Looking,
I don't think they have either. We got to go. No, they've had a couple back here.
A couple, but it seems like they've had little.
I didn't set my computer up because when you got a statistician like Hubble, you don't need one. I just get stuff off him. Well, Bandy will stand back near his goal line inside the 5. Gilbert will stand near midfield to return it. 27-0. Here's Bandy. He bobbled it and barely got it away. And, again, not a great punt. Now, Gates, a great Bluefield roll, though. And now Gilbert will pick it up. Gilbert makes the guy miss. He's trying to turn the corner here, running out of real estate. Now will jig his way to midfield, to the 45, to the 40, to the 35. And, finally, out of bounds about the 33-yard line. A flag back here, though.
Man.
And that's going to be holding on Bethel back here at the 45-yard line.
He looked like an Antonio Brown there.
Let's see if we can pick up the hole here or the block in the back. It's going to be one or the other. He bobbled that thing and kept his poise on and got it away. And then gets a really great roll. Watch this roll. But then watch Gilbert. He's pretty magical back there. Let's see if we can pick up the block in the back or the hole. Let's wait and see. There's one right there. Yep. Proper call.
That's impressive, though, to know that he got the ball that far down the field after that.
Javonte Carter, the go-to culprit there. And that was an easy call for the officials to make. 27-0 Cats in the early minutes here of this second stanza. Of course, the big game tonight, forget Tennessee and Florida. You know, Hubble's a big Florida fan, but the big game tonight is Akron at Kentucky. I'm predicting a Cat 26-point win. That's what the line is.
I'm going to say the plus there is about 26 at least.
You don't start talking lines in this press box when certain people are up here.
I didn't know Sir Hubble was a Florida fan.
Oh, he's a big Florida fan, yeah.
Hubble, I mean, you're a Florida fan over here, huh?
I sometimes question his how big he is, but he's
he had to start off as a Tebow guy like everybody else. I mean, that's how all Florida fans start.
So, 34-yard line, the Cats will have it there. First and 10, they're on 34. 11:45, Collazo. Looks. Dumps it out. Tight end. It's going to be caught by Jacob Bowles, young man from Adamsville, Tennessee, former Cardinal down there. Been to Adamsville a few times with Trinity Christian. Well, McKenzie won again last night. Huntington won again last night. What else is new? No gain on the play. Found Bowles open, but the Bluefield defense found them open. Well, you know this Bluefield team has a lot of pride about them. Good program. Coach Luss is doing a good job up there with Dino and other assistant coaches. You know they've got some pride. They don't want to get blown out of here. 27-0. Here's Collazo looking. Plenty of time.
What an
Dixon
arm.
Wide open.
What an arm.
Dixon at midfield to the 47. First and 10, Cats. You cannot give Collazo that long to throw the football. Let's count it here, Jeremy.
That looked easy.
Let's count it here.
Easy.
All right, that's 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004. 5 seconds to throw that football, and that gives Dixon time to get open as well. You see why Dixon is an All-American. Collazo was a Mid-South Conference Offensive Player of the Year last year as well. Smith moves to the right of him. First and 10 at the 47-yard line. Collazo looks, throws very quickly over the middle, wide open.
Wow.
That's going to be Taylor. Taylor at the 30. Taylor upended there, but another first down. Jalen Taylor from Grandview, Indiana, transfer from Cumberland University, another first down, and Colasso is, it looks like Johnny Unitas out there left-handed.
Yeah, nothing against Bluefield here, but this is right now it looks like man against boys.
He's wide open, wasn't he?
Yeah,
he's just wide open there.
It's very easy.
Timeout across the way, one of the Bluefield players shaking up over there. So let's take a break, 30. The Cats lead the game 27-0 and threatening again. Remember, Red Zone came in today 12 of 12, and they've scored every time today from the Red Zone. Back up to this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Next week, back here again, 12:30 airtime, 1 o'clock, the kickoff. Thomas will come calling. Thomas today, where are they today? I mentioned Point earlier. We played Point. Thomas has a day off today. Reinhardt at Cumberland, Kentucky. Faulkner at Pikeville. Bluefield here at Bethel. Point at Lindsey Wilson. Kentucky Christian at Cumberland, Tennessee. Three teams ranked in the top 25. Bethel, Georgetown, and Lindsey. Bethel, the best ranking at number 7. What's first and 10 now? The ball at the 30-yard line. Colazo in the gun with Smith. Is that Faulkner back in there? Faulkner's in there. In there to block. Wide open out there again to Taylor. And Taylor caught it. Running room inside the 20 down to about the 17-yard line. No disrespect at all to Bluefield. Like Coach Luss. Love Coach Kaklis. But Bethel is making it look really easy, aren't they?
Yeah, Dom and Dave, hey, your predictions here, just a quick question. I mean, you've seen a lot of these teams come up. Looking at the rankings here, of all the Bethel teams you've seen, where would you rank this team ranked upon what you've seen so far out of all your, 13, 14 years?
Been here, this is my 14th year.
All right, so where would you rank this team?
Last year's the best team I've seen because they were 11-0, best record ever in Bethel regular season history. Dearman's team was awfully special as well.
Mm-hmm.
Here's running out of the pocket, catching the receiver open. Again, that Taylor again. Taylor will get another first down. He drags a couple people with him down to inside the 5-yard line. That play originated from the 18. He's inside the 10, had to get to the 8. And that's going to be the chains moving again. It's going to be another first and goal for the Cats. And let's see where they untangle it and mark it. 6-yard line. I mentioned I don't mean to beat a dead horse. Bethel was 12 of 12 in red zone scores this year. And they scored every time today. And about to do it again, I would think. Faulkner, they like to give him the ball in this situation. They don't, though. They go to Colazo in the corner. And couldn't tell that was incomplete. Intended down there.
They've really gone to
Taylor a lot, haven't they?
Yeah, I mean, you've seen number 3 all over the field.
Here's Kenny Williams coming in the game. He'll come in, and Taylor will go out. Well, clock arrested, 8:39 in the half, 27-0 Bethel. And they'll put Faulkner in the pistol this time behind Colazo. Two receivers far side right, one here to the near side on your screen. Great shot there by Worthy Road Studios in the ballgame blitz. Faulkner time. Faulkner dancing, scooting, still on his feet, grinding. Didn't get much. Maybe got to about the 5. Another Bluefield player's lost his helmet.
Second time we've seen that today,
I believe. Yeah, the third time. Banks will go out of the game. They'll bring a reserve in for him. So it's going to be third and goal about just inside the 5, between the 4 and the 5. Go to the horse races. We don't bet. Go there and bet in the 4th race on the 5 horse. Here is Colazo. Sends Faulkner just to his right a little bit. Let's see who he goes to this time. What will Coach Bright dial up? Looking right. Nothing there. Still looking. Running out of real estate, has to toss it incomplete. Good decision by Colazo. He makes great decisions. I bragged on him last year, likewise this year. Nothing there, so he just threw it away, and they'll bring in Welch. Now, marker on the play after all of that.
And you have to
holding on the Cats.
You have to give Bluefield's defense a little credit here. They've stepped up the past few plays, and they're starting to pick up on things. And,
yeah, they've got some pride about them, no doubt about it.
They absolutely do, and they're not giving up in this game.
So that's going to be a penalty on the Cats. That'll move them back now to the 15, or the 14, actually. Going to remain now third down and goal. If you had to kick a field goal from here, be about a 31-yarder. So Colazo will have Faulkner behind him. Dixon and Burris are to the near side. Williams far side right. Colazo looks, throws out here, is caught, and Dixon lost his footing at the 10. Tried to catch it, then make a quick cut. Caught it, but then fell down, and it's going to bring out Welch attempting a field goal. Let's see where they'll mark it. Going to mark the ball at about the 17-yard line. Be a 27-yard left hash attempt. Clock running, 7.5 left. And Welch trying to boot it through. Snap back, ball down. Kick up. The kick is fluttering toward the end zone, and it is up, and it is good.
It's good.
Welch knocks it in, and the Cats up their lead to 30-0 at 7:14. Back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Welcome back, everybody. Dave McCulley, Claire Craddock, the only sane person in the box at times. 30-0. Crash Craddock is listening, by the way. Big hello to her dad, Crash. Brian Craddock. I like to refer to him as Crash. Big hello to Crash. I meant to do that earlier. I hope he's still listening. I forgot to do that, Claire. But Crash Craddock, my favorite names of all time. Here's Johnson to kick away. Got a strong right leg. Let's see if this one reaches the end zone. It is up, and it is not going to quite get there. It's going to be caught at about 3-yard line, then dropped down there.
It's going to be at the one.
And dropped it out of bounds. Boy, the special teams today have hurt.
That's going to be right at the one.
At the 1-yard line. Did it go out of bounds at the one?
It went out, I think, right around the one, which is going to make it pretty.
No, they say it goes in.
Yeah, it didn't look like it went in.
It'd be at 25-yard line. So let's see the replay there. Christopher and the gang will show that to us. They may have already. I may have missed it. I apologize. Worthy Road Studios, the ball game blitz. Paul Schultz at the game. Did Paul, I know he's in the bucket truck. Did it ever go high for him down there? Down to our left? Is he still at field level?
I couldn't tell you.
There he is. I see him down there now, yeah. Now, that's the shots we were getting earlier. He made me think he was going way up in the sky with that thing. Back to throw.
Ooh,
oh, my goodness, what a hit.
Oh,
what a hit.
A little helmet came off by the Bethel player there that just took
Jules Gray
hit.
Caught it.
I don't know who got hit harder, I think it was
the cat that hit him. Let's see who got him here. Hershnick found him open. Good pass there that time.
Ooh.
And watch this hit. Oh, my goodness. Trying to pick out that number. Who got it?
I don't know. I see a little red hair for there for the Bethel player. So,
is that Franks?
Possibly.
Brody got him? Brody Franks.
Man, that was a tough hit.
No, Brody Franks did not start this year in the first game. Here's a guy that had 99 tackles a couple years ago. Hmm. How deep is this team? He started today, but didn't start early in the year. Franks is up. He's a tough cookie. One of the more popular Wildcats on campus, isn't he, Claire? And Hubble. He's one of the more popular guys.
I mean, he looks pretty tough walking off that field right now.
From Moulton, Alabama. Wow. Lawrence County High School. He's a really nice guy.
Like a brick house.
If you saw him in the hallways, he always speaks yes or no, sir. So at the 30-yard line, that's a pickup of 5, second down and 5. University Parkway our drive is pretty busy right now. Sir, you need a muffler. It is second down and 5, the ball at the 30. He needs a muffler badly.
Yeah,
here's Hershnick trying to go for the money ball downfield.
Oh,
incomplete. And they get a flag. going to be too much bumping, I think.
Yeah, he threw that into traffic. So that's a fortunate call for Bluefield there, just to even throw that into that traffic.
Sure is. Rainey and Hughes were back there covering. And it was a lot of bumping, to be honest with you.
It was.
Impeded his progress or ability to get downfield.
You had 3-on-1 there, though, so that was
that's a proper call. First down, automatic first down. They'll mark it off from the previous spot. Beautiful day here. And hot down on the field and in the stands, but it could be worse, folks. It is still September. Second down. I'll make it first down now at their 45. Have they been in Bethel territory today? I don't think so.
I do not believe so.
49, that's right. 49. Hubble says 49. That's why we paid
barely
the big buck.
Above.
Hershey runs out of the pocket. Finds a man open. He caught it. And it's going to be caught this time. Good play there by Gilmore, who bailed his quarterback out. He was the outlet guy. And that's a nice pickup. This Bluefield team coming in 2-0. And averaging 42 points a game. Bethel's defense has been just great today. And they have the ball for the second time in Bethel territory, this time at the 47. First and 10 there. Triple is right below us here on your screen there. Hershey in trouble. Ooh. In trouble.
Flag down.
Sack back to 39.
That's going to be a
holding. That's going to be a holding on Bluefield, I would think. And they're going to decline it. It's going to be holding on the Rams, and you saw Mike Jasper do his hands right around his belt level and said, nope, we're not taking that. We got the sack, and that'll cost them the down. So it's going to be now third down. Tremaine Baker, big offensive lineman from Norfolk, was a guilty guy. So it's going to now be now third and 14, the ball back at the 41. The Cats led the game at the end of 20-0. They lead now 30-0. Highest scoring team in the country. And right now they look every bit of that against a really pretty good football team from Bluefield. Triples, top of your screen. One single receiver here, single coverage here is Javonte Carter on him. Hershey gets out of the pocket, finds the man open, and then pop, but he's got enough for the first down.
I think he's a yard short there.
A big hit by Hughes, but a nice catch that time, knowing he's going to hit Monroe. No, he got it.
They're going to mark it there, but it looked like he was about a yard short.
I think he got about a yard. I thought he had it. The surgery paid dividends. At the 45-yard line, first, that's a nice patient call by Hershey that time. Got it away, and a nice play. The receiver, Monroe, came back and bailed him out. Three down lineman.
Great catch.
Linebackers creeping up there. Here's the pass out in the flat this time again. Caught spinning, trying to get away from the would-be tacklers, Gilmore, but not much, maybe a yard, and that's it. Second and 9. 5.5 left here in this first half. Bethel leads 30-0 on a sun-drenched crowd here at Wildcat Stadium. You talked to a friend of yours today, Lee Carr, the very lovely cheerleader coach here. Y'all went to school together?
I did. Her brother, Bo, good golfing friend of mine.
Little lefty, wasn't he? Yeah.
Phil, like yourself there, Tom and Dave.
Here is Hershey running out of trouble. Now double clutching. Finds a relief pass. It's going to be caught. And that's caught this time by Monroe. He's on his feet for the first down. Breaks a tackle. Breaks another tackle. 25 down. Refuses to go down. And down to the 18. Make it 19-yard line. What a great, great effort by one Nate Monroe.
Well, and the one thing that you have to give Bluefield credit for is, 30 zip at this point in the game. They are not giving up. And they are really moving. They're giving it their all.
Monroe, a junior, a transfer from Frostburg State University. I have to look that up. I've heard of it, but I'm not sure what town that's in.
Not familiar.
Well, they have – look at the receivers top of your screen. They're stacked there. They throw the bubble screen and not much there. They tried to use the old four guys lined up. You'll watch the replay here. They'll use the first three to block for him, but Bethel's defense would have none of that. Watch this replay. We approach the four-minute mark. Well, we didn't have it that time. We apologize, but that's okay. The guys have done yeoman's work. A loss of 2 after all of that. Second down and 12. The ball back to about the 21. 3:50 left in the first half. Empty backfield. One single here. Same setup a moment ago. The fourth receiver stacked up. They use it all as a decoy. They run Herstick here. Down
interception.
In the end zone. It's interception.
Yep.
Great coverage. And that is Demetrius Gilbert.
Wow.
Gilbert played that as well as you can play it. They tried to go against the flow. They had everything looking the other way. And Jeremy Gilbert stayed at home and just made an outstanding defensive play.
And that kind of sums up what we've seen here in the first half, right?
Yeah, that was great play. Gilbert, 5'11", 175, Atlanta Tower High School. Punt return for 74 yards this year, averaging 22.8 on the punt returns. And he just flat got right in front of Nate Monroe and kept him from catching that ball.
He did, for sure.
3:45 in the half. Bethel leading 30-0, wanting more. This heat, even though it's in the low 80s, has got to take its toll on the big lineman. Takes less toll when you're ahead 30-0 than it does when you're down 30-0.
Yeah, it was so cold when we came in this.
But you know now why I had it cold
today, but now it's warmed up quite a bit.
Pass out to Smith. Smith trying to make someone miss, and they drag him out of bounds at about the 22. Didn't get much, maybe a couple, two or three. Nice defense there by Elijah Padgett. Also, Stacy Wilson there on the stop. Second eight, and that's well defended that time by the Rams. The Bluefield Rams. Boy, it's beautiful up there in the mountains. Bluefield, West Virginia. Bluefield, Virginia.
Sounds beautiful. Never been down today.
What was up? I'm trying to think of the school that your mother and I went to years ago.
When Lambeth played there, I knew
you Virginia
guys.
It was Virginia Tech. I'll tell you about that in a minute. Here's Palazzo. Pass, short pass, caught by Taylor. We actually went to, I think it was Virginia Tech. The press box was in one state, and the field was in the other.
Was that back in the days of JoJo Jones?
That was back in the days of JoJo had already gone. But that
JoJo had already gone. Vic Wallace was still there.
That's right, Coach Wallace.
Coach Wallace.
Hall of Famer. Third down and four. 2:40 the clock running. The Cats have not been denied much today. Let's see if they can convert today. Remember, 47% in third down conversions on the year. Doubles at the bottom of your screen. Run receiver high top of it there. Collazo, the third down and four. Looks, throws. Man, wide open. Wide open at the 40. That's going to be, this time, Jalen Taylor. Well, Taylor came in here today with five receptions. Dixon and Burris, one and two. He's at third, and he's racked him up today, and he was wide open first and 10 at the 40.
Does it look easy what Collazo's doing, or is it just me?
He's just well-schooled, patient, poised.
Wow.
He's one of my work studies, too. Works in our office with us.
That's awesome.
During the non-football year. Collazo runs out of trouble, looking for a block, finds one. Midfield, 45, 40, on his feet inside the 40, and knocked out of bounds, finally, about the 38. His decision-making is superb, folks.
He has been fun to watch today.
Watch him here.
That's fun to watch.
He was directing what he wanted, didn't he? Got the block.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's just controlling what he wants to do.
No doubt about it. It's going to be another first down. We'll give you all the stats at halftime. 38-yard line, first and 10. Cats already lead the game 30-0. They're a well-oiled machine today. Collazo looks, throws over the middle. It's caught by Burris. Make it Taylor again. Excuse me. Burris wears 7, Diamond Dave. Taylor wears number 3. Get used to that. At the 20, another first down.
Taylor has been a beast for the Bethel offense as well.
Young lady, Michelle Singer, one of the officials here today across the way. She directed the change down to the other end of the field deeper. So at the 20, it's first and 10. A minute 31 left in the half. And Bethel has just absolutely dominated the game from the get-go. Remember the first pass to Dixon. Collazo looks, double clutches, throws out there. It's caught by Kenny Williams. Williams inside the 10. And will be knocked down at about the 12. Picks up 9. Second and 1. A lot of weapons.
Weapons, I mean, it's pretty impressive what I've seen today. I haven't seen Bethel here in a couple of years since I've been on the air with you, but today it's just been – they've been unstoppable.
Second and a yard out here and dropped. Dropped by Partee. I think Partee wanted to turn downfield before he caught it. Your lovely mom, Peggy McCulley, watching today.
Hello, Miss Peggy.
Third and a yard at the 12-yard line. They got to get right at the 11. Back in the game for the Cats. Jacob Bowes, a tight end from Adamsville, going with more power that time and blocking if they need it. Smith is back in there at the running back position. Dixon is single coverage here on this near side. Boy, that's got to be dangerous to you folks watching from Bluefield. They're going to go to Dixon. Collazo awaiting the snap in the gun. No, he goes the other way, and that's going to be incomplete. Kenny Williams tried to get on the slant pattern and just well defended here. This is a great bit of defense by Bluefield.
Great defense by Bluefield for sure there.
Fourth and a yard at the 12. The Cats, I don't see Welch coming out there, so the Cats are going to go for it.
I guess, sitting at 30 zip with 45 seconds left is understandable.
Yeah, let's see why Coach Bright rings up here, the offensive coordinator. Smith to the left of Collazo. Smith has it. Smith has the yard. He has more. He's inside the 10, down to about the 9. First and goal for the Cats. Well, big offensive line. Surratt, Wynn, Shabazz. Wynn's not starting, Dave. Shabazz, Taylor, and Morales. Timeout Cats. They lead the game 30-0, 39 seconds and a half. And they've got it first and goal again when we come back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntington. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Well, the left-handed arm of Collazo, the catching ability of the receivers and the running of Smith and others. The Cats have dominated the game. Welcome back, everybody. Diamond Dave McCulley. Good to work with our son, Jeremy McCulley, today. He's done basketball with me before, making his debut. He's filling in for Craig Lund today. Craig up in Murfreesboro working for Bethel University. He's an employee here, does our color, also the voice of the McKenzie Rebels, one of them. And, Craig, you missed another great one here by the Cats offensively. Craig counting the hours down. He says they're going to drain something tonight down in Florida. I'm not sure what he's talking about. Collazo will move Smith to his right. Doubles far side left. Collazo, play fake. Looks, got a man wide open. Caught. That is caught, ladies and gentlemen, by Tyrell Partee, the tight end.
Easy.
That is Partee's first touchdown as a Wildcat. So with 32 seconds left, the Cats just adding on to what is already an impressive performance, 36-0. Pass to Partee from about 6 yards out. In to attempt the PAT will be Welch. Partee wears number 9. Here's the snap back, ball down, kick up, and Welch has only missed 2 all year. It's 37-0, Bethel.
Wow.
Back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. 4 locations to serve you: Camden, Huntington, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to Wildcat Stadium. Coach Nelson's in the house. He'll be our halftime guest talking about Lady Wildcat basketball. It was photo ops the other day for them. We did those, and then they did a lot on their own. And lovely gals. Coach Cal, one of my favorite players.
Nelson Calipari over here.
Yeah, Nelson Calipari. Here's the kick. And it's going to die right at about the 15-yard line. The Cats have a hand, get a hand on it, but I think Bluefield came up with it. You're watching the replay here. They're special teams. I'm not picking on them, but, boy, they have really struggled today, haven't they?
Man, they really have. And, you know, Bluefield's, they've really tried to battle in this game to stay.
That ball recovered, by the way, for our statisticians' purposes. Jamonte Chavis recovered that 89, Hubble.
helpful did you get that there?
14-yard line, first and 10 there, and you would think probably the couple of running plays by Bluefield, and they'll try to regroup here at halftime. 37-0, and this is a pretty good Bluefield team, and Bethel's just taking them apart. Next week, Thomas will come calling. Could get interesting after that. Bethel has to go to the Cumberlands. I'm not taking anything away from Thomas either. Bethel will be heavy favorite here, but can't take anyone for granted, but can't look ahead to the Cumberlands, which I was doing. I apologize. Hershey drops back in the pocket, being flushed out of there again. Finds his relief valve, and it's going to be caught by Jules Gray. Good to see Jules Gray out there. He was the guy that took that hit a moment ago, but actually Brody Franks took the worst end of it than Gray did.
He did. And I tell you, look, talking back at Hershey, I mean, you got to think about him looking back there. You got to be nervous back there in the backfield with all that Bethel defense coming at you today.
Yeah. Chris Nelson, Coach Nelson, Craig Lund sent me a message and said they're going to drain something in Florida tonight. What's he talking about?
The swamp?
Not
the swamp?
Of, I'm not sure what that's about. Here's a man wide open. Midfield, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15. Knocked out of bounds finally inside the 15-yard line. Hurstick, that time, caught Thomas Lee, wide receiver from Apton, Virginia, Halifax County High School. And, boy, he just did a great job getting open. I'm not sure how he got so open, but he did. And credit Hurstick. It's been a tough day for him, but the little guy stood back there and found his receiver wide open with 8 seconds left in the half.
He's been tough. That's as far as we've seen Bluefield move the ball today.
Going to be first and 10. Just outside the 10. I think it's first and goal at the 10. Excuse me. Timeout. Marker on the play. Illegal substitution, I think. Anthony Shipton was in the game. They brought him out. He's going to go down and talk to Caden Carter, the trainer. Looks like he may have an equipment problem. He may something about his pads. He may go straight to the locker room. I think that's where they're taking him. Either he's got an equipment problem. Jason Esri's followed him. Personal foul on Shipton. Oh, he's been ejected.
Is that targeting?
I must have thrown a – I'm not sure. Have we got that guy's on replay? Do we have that?
Okay, sorry about that. That'd be some kind of targeting to get thrown out of that game.
I don't want to speculate, but when you're ejected like that, you've either done something to the official or thrown a punch or something. I'm not sure, but he went straight to the dressing room.
He's not looking back.
No, and well, he shouldn't. Here is the pass in the end zone. Incomplete. Down to 4 seconds now left. Didn't see what happened, but Shipton going to the house. He's from Orange, California, Texas State transfer, but he went immediately walking right to the dressing room. I thought maybe it was an equipment problem. That's what we were hoping it was. It's going to be second and goal. Well, maybe one shot at it, then kick the field goal. I guess when you're down 37-0, you just try to go in the end zone and get some points that way and forget the field goal. It'd be tough to get a field goal with 4 seconds anyway. I mean, you'd have to just throw it away with real quick, maybe get a second left on it, and that's it. Hershey in that shotgun with his running back to his right. He's going to throw it out here in the flat, and they try to get the big tight end open. He's not going to go anywhere. The Cats are going to got him there. I think that's going to be an illegal pass anyway. They haven't thrown a flag. I thought that was a forward pass, but Burns picked it off. Let's see if Burns gets credit for the interception. Well, no flag, so I guess it was a legal pass. We're at halftime. Doesn't matter right now other than Burns' stats, which he would be very conscious of, and I would be too. The score at halftime, Bethel 37, Bluefield nothing. We'll take a two-minute break, be back with stats, scoring recap, and Coach Chris Nelson. It's all coming up next after this two-minute message on the Bethel Football Network.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square.
featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntington. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
Well, welcome back, everybody. Welcome back here at halftime, the Renaissance Band under the direction of Dr. Derek Jones. I'm sure he knows who Dr. J. Julian is, or was, the late band director of the Tennessee Band through the years. But I always like to do that with Dr. Jones. He is a really nice guy, does a great job. We have the stats here we'll have for you in just a matter of moments. Coach Nelson's going to join us in a matter of moments as well. Good to see you, buddy. But the Cats lead the game 37-0. We'll quickly go over some stats for you. First downs, Bethel 23, Bluefield 7. Bethel in the game, 388 total yards to 191 for Bluefield. Meanwhile, Collazo's just been superb. How about coming in this thing, 21 of 26, almost 300 yards, 297, four touchdowns. Rushing in the game as well has been Collazo with 28 yards. 33 by Smith, 24 by Burris, and 19 by Faulkner. For the Bluefield team, only 1 yard rushing. Actually, they were minus 1 yard rushing in the first half. They rushed the ball 9 times for only a yard. We mentioned coming in the game today, they'd only averaged 88 yards per rush. But looking at this, it's just been all Bethel. 21 of 26 Collazo, 388 yards. In total offense, 297, 91 on the ground, 297 in the air, 192 yards passing, much of that on that one big play a moment ago at the end of the half. It's been all Bethel in the thing. Collazo passes to Dixon, 15 yards to open up, 6-0. PAT by Welch was no good. At the 9:43 mark, Collazo again caught Dixon again, this time for 29 yards out. Welch, the PAT, made it 13-0. Collazo rushed for 7 yards. Remember that left end zone little rush he had. Third rushing touchdown of the year for the lefty, 19-0. Welch made it 20-0 at the end of one. Collazo then passed to Dixon again, 5 yards this time. That made it 26-0. The PAT made it 27-0 by Welch. Welch, a field goal from 27 yards out, made it 30-0. And then it was Collazo, a pass complete to Partee near the end of the half, 32 seconds left. And it made it 30-0 here at the break. We'll have more stats for you at the end of the game. Be sure and stay tuned for that. Read about the game tonight at BethelAthletics.com. By the way, cross country today, we understand that we had a young man that finished third. De La Rosa finished, I think, seventh on the women's side. That was down in Memphis today with Coach Kilburn and the gang. Congratulations to them. And the Soccer Cats today, 13th in the nation. They will be at St. Louis tonight, and they will take on a good, pretty good Missouri Baptist team. The record wouldn't indicate it, but at one time they were ranked. I think they're 1-2-1 now, but they will be playing there tonight at St. Louis. That originally was scheduled for 4 o'clock. They moved it to 6. You can go to BethelAthletics.com and see the stats and the video watch. You can see how to watch that game and follow on stats as well. Coach Chris Nelson is going to join us and talk about this first half in football. And then we'll talk a little bit about his Lady Wildcats as well. Coach Nelson, great to have you with us, and good to have you with us on the air here. And we wait, Coach, now you got his headset on now. So we will tell you that the Lady Wildcats have looked good here in the preseason. Of course, you can't just start being able to practice with them, Coach, but it's one of those guys, one of those deals that you got some great veterans coming back and you got some newcomers. Tell me a little bit about, first of all, your assessment of how things have gone thus far getting ready for the season.
Well, we get to start up officially Monday.
Monday, that's right.
So our weights have been great. Coach Batts has done a good job in the weight room with them, and then conditioning Coach Reagan and Coach Vaughn's put them pretty rigorous workouts. We run on Tuesdays and Thursdays, so we're probably in better shape this time of year just because we couldn't start practice. So they're ready to get started. Monday can't come soon enough, and we got a nice group.
Coach Vaughn comes back another year with you, and you have a new graduate assistant as well.
Yeah, Coach Reagan, you know, played at Murray State for 4 years, and we got a COVID year out of her graduate year. We recruited her out of high school, and then last minute Murray State came in and got her from us, and she's just been great. You know, last year we only had 1 year to coach her, but she's been terrific. Coach Ray, I think that's what she's going to go by with. But the girls respect her. She's got great work ethic, very organized, great shooter as a player, and she's passing on that that stuff to our players.
Good group of veterans coming back. Talk about them if you would.
Well, it starts with a point guard. You know, you got Callan Howard from Covington, junior. She's our leader. You know, I always say this, big shoes to fill when you name these names, but she's the Morgan Martins, Millie Bryant, Jacqueline Street. She reminds me of those kids, this tough nose, local kid, and she works up here with you. Just dependable. You know, you got a point guard that don't turn it over a lot, you got a chance to be pretty good. And then Madison Hart being our trail forward, Gibson County. Went to Gibson County to recruit yesterday, her sister. Madison's this special player, and just amazing how much she's matured in just a year's time as far as off the court, how she's communicating, opening up. And then Aaliyah Lee, our five, our post kid, got a 6'2 presence in the post. So, you know, last year that's why we struggled. I thought we were just so inexperienced, and that's why you saw us playing so well late in the year, because experience pays off. So that's what we're excited about. You know, Haley Cavendish from Dyer County, she's battled a little foot thing in the preseason. She really came on last year and then broke her foot about midway through the semester. So we're expecting a lot out of those kids.
I know, and happy to have – always good to have the veterans back. But these are not only really good players, but good kids.
Great kids. You know, that's why we went with the 6 freshmen, 1 transfer this year. I just think we have a lot of high-character kids. Proof's in the pudding with their parents, with their GPA. You don't have to worry about so much stuff. You know, you're going to have your normal stuff, and you know, they're college kids, but we just don't have to worry about a lot of stuff off the court.
Chris, talk about some of those newcomers. I know you've got a good mix of post players plus guards.
Yeah, we do. You know, Laura Nichols from Creekwood, left-handed. We recruited her heavy. I think she's going to be a nice stretch 3/4 for us. You know, something about left-handed kids, they can really score it. So we're excited about her tough nose and conditioning. MJ Simmons from Community. Westview put them out in the state tournament. I think we can get a nice high-low action with her and Madison Hart. Lauren Bryant from Wayne County, another state runner-up team. Kylie Reynolds, McKenzie, everybody's familiar with her. I think she can really shoot it. She battled a little Achilles here in the preseason, but she's familiar with the dribble drive we run because Coach Wilkins has her prepared from the high school. Maya Sutton's going to have a chance to play some point. Give Cal some rest. She's from Oakland. And we might play a Nia Patterson at the point. Well, you know, she's a fifth-year senior for us. So we got a really good group. Our transfer is from Central Missouri, Alyssa Morris. We got to give credit to Coach Vaughn and getting her. Central Missouri, you know, traditionally in the Final Four of D2. We think she can really score, really shoot it. So we're excited about our group.
37-0 here at halftime. The Cats have owned the game. They led 20-0 at the end of the first quarter. They lead 37-0 now. And, Coach, let's talk a little bit about the schedule. I know a different look. First of all, a different look to the league this year.
Yeah, it is. One kid I failed to mention was Carmen Frost.
Crockett County.
Yeah, I was going off the cusp when I mentioned Anaya Patterson. You know, you play for Kayla Hudson, Irvin, you're prepared. And Carmen reminds us a lot of Rachel, just a tough-nosed kid. All those kids we just mentioned are local kids from local product, local coaches. So, hopefully, they're tough enough or prepared to do, like you just mentioned, the schedule we have. It's a little different now. Mid-South, I wouldn't say dismantled, just sort of dwindled down. We don't get a conference game until January 13th, and that makes it really hard scheduling, as you know, in the month of December to find games. But we got creative. We added Oakland City, who made the national tournament, Philander Smith, who's in the national tournament out of Little Rock, Bruton Parker, who used to be in the league with us, made the national tournament last year. So we added those teams, and we'll open up the first weekend with Pharmacy out of St. Louis.
And, of course, you look at the league, not as many teams in the league, but the people that have been tough, still tough, aren't they?
It is. You know, I talk to Ginger at Campbellsville quite often. You know, we expect them to probably be the preseason favorite. But, you know, after that, you know, it's wide open. You know, Lindsey Wilson finished bottom barrel last year, and traditionally a national tournament team. Freed Hardeman, a rival, Cumberland's. You know, we lose Tennessee Southern / Martin Methodist back to the Southern States. But, you know, it's 7 deep, you know, Georgetown in there. It helps a little bit with travel. But it's just a little different now since we have to wait so long to start conference play. But last year I thought we were good enough to be in the national tournament. It's just our record because our conference beat us up so bad. So hopefully we'll be able to get some wins in the preseason and find our way back to the national tournament where we've been in past years.
And behind every program, and just like you and here at Bethel, some really good coaches in this league. Yeah, I mean, every night you can be at the bottom of our league and still be, as you said, a pretty really, really good, and not that we're at the bottom, but you can really still be a good basketball team.
You're right. You know, I was 25 years old when I started. We were in the Trans-South, got humble quick, learned from those great coaches. Southern States had a lot of good coaching friends, and back to the Mid-South, for Coach Vaughn being a really good assistant, the scouts and stuff he has to do really helps him out, you know, coaching wise, because you're preparing against great coaches. And you just mentioned it, we were middle of the pack 2 years ago, and we went out to Omaha and made it to the Sweet 16 sure. in Sioux City, Iowa. So that just shows, I think, and last year, same thing. I think you see, if you finish, well, now it's seven teams. I think seven of our teams are very capable of getting to the national tournament. I know that sounds crazy, but that's how deep and talented our teams are, and then just well coached.
I could very well see five as a minimum of getting in, and maybe even more.
Yeah, you know, and that's always, you hope so. You hope everybody's scheduled appropriate, and you just beat up on each other in the league. And if you get to the national tournament, it's free game like it was 2 years ago for us. But like I said, great coaches. This level is very challenging. Like, it's equivalent, you know, you have some lower D2 teams, you have some lower NAIA teams, but when you get to top NAIA and top of D2, you got some really good teams. We're going to scrimmage Union October 17th at their place, the scrimmage, and then we'll do an exhibition with Lee University, two former NAIA powerhouses. We'll scrimmage Lee late December and go to their place.
You're going to see Mark and Marty.
Yeah, great coaches I look up to, great coaches I learned a lot from, great coaches I still stay in contact with. So, you know, those are good for us. We'll see Union before we start season, and then we'll see Lee before we start conference season. So hopefully that exposes us, gives us the experience we need, and hopefully play well.
Next week we'll have the swimming and bowling watch list. They'll do one for basketball in about a month probably as well. So we'll have at least three players in that watch list to watch for too.
Yeah, I think so. And we'll probably go.
I missed the preseason poll though.
It'll be a little later.
Yeah.
The preseason poll. Oh,
I'm talking about the conference poll.
The fact that I do too. You know, that's just a conference thing. I don't know why we don't do it. But nationally it'll still come out. Preseason poll. But, you know, that just, any type of media coverage, as you know, just gives you hype. Gives something for the kids to look forward to. And, you know, our big three, obviously, going in the year, Madison, Hart, Cal, and Aaliyah, we know what we're getting. And when you got a foundation of a 1-4-5, you know, the holes of 2 and 3 are big to fill, but you feel strong about going. Those are sure. three really good players.
Any rule changes I need to know about?
I'd have to know about them too, so
I didn't mean to put you on the spot. I was just, but I'm normally sure there's some, but I don't remember seeing any of this far.
I get emails on it, and I'm actually on those committees, and I'll just have to reread that before.
Well, if you and I don't know anything in a week or two, we'll call Rush Davis. He'll know.
Well, you know, I was always, you know, I never knew how many timeouts we had or anything when Coach Hubble was with me, so I just have to guess
and
all the time.
Speaking of that, we did leave off one important member of your coaching staff.
The most important. Yeah. She's actually mowing the yard as we speak, Coach Nelson.
Wait a minute. You're out here talking to me in this air-conditioned press box, and Jen's mowing the yard?
Well, she told me Jeremy was at the house earlier. She's going to go to Paris and shop, and then she came back to the house. She goes, you know, I don't think I'm going to go to the game. I'm just going to listen to it and mow the yard, and then we're going to watch Florida-Tennessee tonight with some friends of ours. So
you are, according to Craig Lund, going to watch that swamp drain.
It comes on PBS, right? No, I'm just playing.
That's Chris Nelson.
That's a total
folks.
Joke.
That's Chris Nelson, not Diamond Dave. But, Chris, great to have you with us. Like the shirt.
Thank you.
Appreciate you taking care of my boy this morning until game time.
Always good to catch up.
All right, Coach Chris Nelson joins us as he joins us here on the halftime segment. About 5 minutes before we tip it off, or kick it off, see a good shot there by Worthy Road Studios and the Ball Game Blitz. Christopher and the gang doing a great job showing the band and the crowd as they have the umbrellas up here at Wildcat State. The Cats lead the game, I think I said earlier, 30-0. It's actually 37-0 here at the break. 2 minute break, back with more halftime activities after this on the Bethel Football Network.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit, call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
We are back here at Wildcat Stadium. Next week, we'll be back here at 12:30, the good Lord willing, and the creeks don't rise. 1 o'clock, Thomas University will come calling. Wildcats, after winning 77-0 last week, beating a pretty good Bluefield team today, 37-0 here at the break. Dave McCulley along with Jeremy McCulley. Bethel, number 7 in the country. Lindsey Wilson, number 11. Georgetown, number 12. And the Cats running away with this one at the moment. Bethel University and Worthy Road Studios have teamed up this season, as you might already know. A partnership between the two, the coverage of Bethel athletic events, football, and some basketball. Worthy Roads also produces live broadcasts of the Jackson Rockabilly baseball team, Union University Sports, Trenton Peabody, Jackson Christian, University School of Jackson, and Trinity Christian. The Ball Game Blitz, the best source of West Tennessee, is all produced by Worthy Road Studios. And by the way, I'll turn around and ask our producer and director, Christopher Reason. This will be posted later on Facebook, I guess, or YouTube or whatever, later tonight. Oh, right after, okay, and they'll post that. And you can tell your folks, if you missed the game, they can watch it later on YouTube, Worthy Road Studios and the Ball Game Blitz providing that. The Cats led 20-0 at the end of one. They lead 37-0 here. And Bethel coming in this ball game 2-0, Bluefield 2-0 as well. Let's do this. Let's take another break, a one-minute break. WEIO's coverage with Tom Yarbrough and the gang, Brandy and the gang at Flagship Station. Let's take a one-minute break. We'll come back with the second half with Bethel leading 37-0 here on the Bethel Football Network.
Going. The First Move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntingdon. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
Our producer and director on the video side, Christopher Reason, is telling me that we have some replays for you. And we're going to go to those right now. Here's the first touchdown, or one of the touchdowns that Bethel had. Colasso back in that shotgun. Have a couple of touchdowns to show you, and the interception near the end of the first half. Colasso dropping back. Here's that pass to Dixon. What a catch by Dixon. Great job, guys, with the camera. And a great job by J.D. Dixon as he caught that one that time for the score. Here's another score. You see Collazo on that gun again. And he's going to look. And here's the pass in the end zone. And this one caught this time by Partee, the tight end. That was right before the half. And here's the interception. This should be the Burns interception here, as he'll sneak in there and get it. Now, that was a lateral, so that was a good no call by the official. Now, the tight end will throw the ball, and you'll see Burns step in here. And Darian Burns has his second INT. The first was returned for a touchdown, and this one sealed the deal there in the ball game blitz. And Worthy Road Studios showing a great job, guys. Super job with those replays. As we have Ashley Janda on the replay. Ashley, great job. I know her granddad. Jimmy, a longtime baseball card collector, and yours truly. We have traded a few cards through the years. Well, Bethel leads the game 37-0. I saw Kennedy and Eric down there. They were down there working hard in the sun. Kennedy still looks real refreshed, and Eric looks like he's about to pass out behind me back out here. It's been nice and cozy up here, guys, nice and cool. Yeah. But two of our SID staff members, and Kennedy's our GA this year. And Eric's been with us now for a couple of years. And here is the kick by Johnson to start this second half, with Bethel leading 37-0. Back inside the five, and he's going to bring it out of there. And that's going to be, in this case, Nate Monroe brings it out. And Monroe gets it up field for a few yards, up to about the short of the 50. Let's see where they mark it. Josh Key, our public address announcer, he's like Craig Lund. He's getting nervous. What time is it? Let's see what time it is here, folks. Central Standard Time for you folks in Bluefield. It's 2:38 here. 3:38 late afternoon there for you folks with Nicole and Gabby and Bella. But and Bob Redd, the very fine SID there. But Bob's like me. He's not here today, but he's writing the story. So when the game ends, he'll be through, and I'll go home to Jackson and still be laboring. Not like last week, though. We had two soccer matches after the football game. We like to never get out of here. Here's the handoff. Running it will be Lamp. Lamp's going to get a few yards up to about the 20. That ball was marked at about the 14, so he's going to get pretty good yardage out of that, more than I thought. From the 14, he scurries. And he's up to the 20. Hand off, nothing much this time. Running back hits the hole, and the Cats close the door. They untangle the bodies here in front of you. The Cat tackle was by, who made that tackle, guys? 86 made the tackle, Claire tells me. Christian Matthews, the senior, made it. So it's going to be third down and still three from the 20-yard line. Cats and the three-down linemen, 3-4 defense there. Here is the pass out here in the flat. It's going to be caught and turning upfield for the first down. Will be Nate Monroe. Monroe's done a pretty good job for them, Jeremy.
Yeah, he seems to be. Sorry, I just got back up here to the booth. Been spending a little time with Coach Nelson.
Yep, good to see Chris. Did a great job of the interview. The ball will be marked at the 28-yard line, first and 10 there. Clock running, 13 and a half left in the third. Bethel leads 37-0. Herstick back there, the quarterback, looks, still looking, being flushed out of that pocket again, and they converge on him, and Timothy Hamilton will get him. Didn't get credit for a sack that time. Hamilton's very athletic. Herstick moved for maybe about a half a yard to a yard. Let's give him a yard. It's going to be second and 9. Hamilton, his own calculator, keeps up with his sacks. Really athletic player, Hamilton. From Chicago, played at Trinity International University. I was up there one time with with Lambeth. And Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan were next door practicing basketball at Trinity University. Here's our international. Here's the pass caught, and it's going to be a first down. Catching it will be Lee. Remember, Lee had the big pass reception late in the half. They couldn't score as we picked it off, but Jeremy Lee's a pretty good receiver.
Yeah, absolutely. He's
big, tall target, 6'3", 210. So another first down. So they've taken it now from their 14 up to their 43. So the coaching staff talked to them at halftime, said, guys, we're playing for some pride. Don't give up. Hershey back there does a full circle. Now he's going to do another one. He's at the 45 to midfield on his feet. Slashes his way for near another first down. I think he may have another one.
You got to give this to Hirschman. He's a little guy, but he's pretty athletic, right?
Hirschman, 5'11", 180, the redshirt junior. Upper Iowa University transfer. Speaking of Iowa, that poll, Northwestern number one, Grandview number two, and Morningside all three, or number three, they're all from the state of Iowa. So the ball will be at the 47-yard line now of Bethel, first and 10. 11:35 in the third. Initial drive of this second half. Hershey looks over the middle. Incomplete. And picked off. Gilbert on the deflection has it. Gilbert will come to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, to the 45. The midfield has a sea of blockers. 45, 30. Cuts it to the 30. He may go. 20-yard line, 15-yard line. On his feet to the 10, to the 5. Stumbles his way. Did he get in? No. He's at the 1-yard line.
Oh,
Gilbert wanted it so bad. Picked it off around the 30. He picked it off around the 30-yard line. He's going to go, ladies and gentlemen. 69 yards on the return down to the 1-yard line. Demetrius Gilbert.
Where'd you have him catch it?
I had him at the 30. Did he catch it? Where'd he catch it? All right, 26. All right, we'll put 4 more yards on that. 73-yard return. I trust our statistician, Derek Hubble. I trust Claire Moore. 11-10. At the 1-yard line, Gilbert brought it back. I couldn't tell. I apologize on that one. Bethel on the year now. How many interceptions today? Two. That's 7 interceptions on the year for Bethel. Collazo under center gives it to Smith. Smith finds end zone. Touchdown, Cats. With 11:06 in the third, the turnover leads to a 1-yard plunge by Martise Smith. And Bethel ups it to 43-0. So we'll give Gilbert a little credit on our stat sheet. Read about the game later tonight on BethelAthletics.com. Lyle the center, Johnson the holder, and Welch, who's only missed 2 PATs all year, will try to knock this one through. 43-0. The turnover and the 73-yard return by Gilbert sets Smith up. Smith pays off. It's up, and it is good. Welch with a PAT. It's 44-0 after the 73-yard interception return by Gilbert and Smith, the 1-yard plunge, a 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. 4 locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
Let's go back here. There we go. Wildcats in that first half, a total of 388 yards. They came in today averaging 443. And they're still tacking it on. They lead the game 44-0. Kick here on the left side and not much there for Jamonte Chavis, St. Petersburg, Virginia. Instead of running north and south, Jeremy, he ran east and west, and you can't do that against this special teams unit of Bethel.
Yeah, you really can't. Bethel's just looked so impressive today.
They really have, and it will be now the ball at the 14, first and 10. Field position's been a big factor of the game, as you might imagine, and then big plays by Bethel. Dixon had touchdown receptions in that first half. So it's 10:57 left here. Smith, touchdown. Partia, touchdown. You name it. Bethel scored. Collazo with a run for a touchdown. Handed off. Running back, bulldozing his way to about the 20. Picked up about 6 yards. Cortez Gilmore. Well, Coach Lusk's been around. He's a veteran. Dino's been around. He's a veteran. One thing you can bet on, this team will not quit despite the fact they're 44. That's a good hard run by Smith. And now a flag comes in. Let's see what that's about. Well, Bethel said something, did something. We're right ahead, shipped and ejected. And unsportsmanlike conduct. Eatman said something to the officials or said something to he's going to come out of the game, and well, he should at the moment. And going in for him will be Kamari Lewis. He's going to come over and cop a play to Coach Jasper. Coach Jasper is going to talk to him. Good coaching by Coach Mike. Not sure what he said, but whatever he said was unacceptable one way or the other. You're leading 44-0, son. That's sort of a selfish play, to be honest with you. Here is the handoff. And now another flag comes in. This may be on Bethel as well. They got Gilmore carrying the ball. And now we got a little chirping going on with each other. That tackle by Bethel's Kendrick Walker that time, number 31, guys. Now, Eamon's going to come back in the game. So Lewis will come right back out. Coach Jasper brought him out, said something to him, puts him back in. And now a flag. And, Jeremy, where that flag came in, that might be – normally it's either holding or a face mask. I think that's going to be a face mask, I think.
Yeah, it looks like a face mask from what I'd seen.
Although Monroe is not happy with – he's actually talking to the white hat, Mr. Stimmel. Now whistles, and let's see what this is about. Now Coach Jasper is going to get an explanation. Well, you want to see the game stay at a pace of being cleanly played, no matter who you pull for in the game. It's going to be on Bethel. We mentioned Bethel coming in here today with 14 penalties, 149 yards. I'm looking down at my stat sheet here on the penalties. Bethel had six in the first half for 61. Bluefield had two for 20. Now Coach Lust is going to come out. He's going to talk to the officials, see what that's about. A little chirping that time among the team. So now Bethel has come here, as you see the huddle there near the near sideline. Coach Jasper, probably, I don't have a mic down there, but I would imagine he's saying, look, guys, we're up 44-0. We're really good. They're a good football team, but I want this thing stopped. I don't want any more penalties and hanky-panky. We don't need it.
I'd say let's keep the clock running at this point.
You get someone ejected for next week and that kind of thing. So now the huddle breaks, as you see. Coach Brewer out there. Coach Springer, that's him right there coming back at the 45-yard line, defensive coordinator. See Davis Prather down there, former great player here. Coach Brewer. He's the guy with the white beard. And the ball hit. They'll move it after the infraction. Unsportsmanlike conduct, I think. He's about, well, he didn't tell us, did he? 45-yard line is where the ball will rest now. First and 10 there for Bluefield. I'm not sure. Well, inadvertent would have been five. I'm not sure what they call. Go down and ask the PA, did they see what that infraction was, if you would, if they saw it. If you would, please. Get Eric to go down and talk to Josh Key about that. Need it for our stats. First down and 10. Hurstick drops back. Being pursued and tackle. What a nice play there.
Hirschman looks a little injured down there at the moment as well. He's taking a beating down there.
Johnson got him. Tyrone Johnson, the redshirt freshman from Birmingham, played at Carver High School. Jeremy, he did all he could to get out of there, but boy, Johnson, he just had a bull rush on him, didn't he?
Yeah, it's going to be a sore ride home for Hirschman.
Well, plan B didn't work. Our other boot doesn't know what the penalty was as well. So it will be now the ball moved back. That's about, what is that, a? Second and 23, a 13-yard loss, Derek Cumble tells us. 9:21 left in the third. Hurstick again. Oh. It's just fair game. Mm. This time bursting through. No one picked up Darian Lewis, a linebacker from Brighton, former Cardinal over there at Brighton High School. And right now Bluefield is going backwards, Jeremy McCulley.
Yeah, they are. I feel like they have basically the entire game here.
You know, one thing you get caught up in is acknowledging how well the offense has played today. They averaged 64. They scored 44. this has been a complete dominating game by Bethel's defense as well.
Absolutely.
I mean, they have been, Kendi agrees with me, this has been a absolute showtime for this. And they're just lowering the ears right now and saying, okay, we're coming at you, stop us.
Yeah, it seemed pretty unfair.
Hershey drops back again in the pocket, throws a dying duck, and out of bounds, I think. Yep, out of bounds. A nice effort that time by Monroe, but he was out of bounds, and they'll have to punt the ball. It's going to be Monroe getting some chirping from the bench. He's just waving and said, I don't need to hear that. So at the 22, they'll have to punt it on a fourth and a long, long way. They've got to get almost to Atwood. Bandy to punt it away. Well, maybe not Atwood, but to Tresvant anyway. You're going through Tresvant. Watch them, folks. They set up over there and just try to get you. Bandy will get it away from about his 10. Gilbert stands back at the 40, his own 40. Bethel could come out of this with a great high snap, gets it away, and it may have been partially blocked. I think it was. No flag, and the punter hit the deck, and now it's Gilbert running up here around the 45. No flag, so it must have been deflected and blocked. Back there on that coverage was Tyrone Wash, also Jordan Kaysen. One of those guys may have got a hand on it. I think they did. So it's going to be first and 10 for the Cats, leading the game 44-0, and they're deep in, well, not that deep, but they're still in Bluefield territory at the 46. Bethel led 20-0 at the end of one, 37-0 at halftime, and 44-0 here now. Colazo's still in there, quarterback. Mitchell Faulkner to his right. Looks to the right. Throws. Burris caught it and hurdles his way over the defender. Dixon gave him a good block, picked the first guy off, and then Burris sort of picked the next guy off. He hurdled that time. Woof. Woof, woof. Tyrese Woof from Vicksburg, Mississippi, from Hines Junior College. Boy, that's turned out a lot of great players in Hines down in Mississippi. Second down and one from the 36-37. Colazo looks. Colazo throws. Deflected. Nice play there defensively. With a deflected ball is Jared Hawk. He spells it H-O-C-H, but he pronounces it like you're flying, a hawk. It's going to be third down and a yard. Hawk is from Georgia. So it's going to be third down a yard. Bethel, I think, throwing at that time, Jeremy, on the short yardage, thinking they'd get it running it anyway. Two down territory here, leading 44-0 anyway. 7:53 left in the third. My statistician's making fun of me. And now they didn't jump all sides. Boy, great. Well, I guess maybe they did. Or did Bethel? Was it illegal procedure? They had a guy. Yeah, it was a false start. What happened, Jeremy? It looked like they were going to jump all sides. One guy ran into his own guy. They didn't jump all sides, but Bethel thought they did, and so they snapped it, and it was illegal procedure.
A little stalled there for a moment.
Burris will come back at the game, and out will be Partee, who has a touchdown catch. We don't talk about Burris enough. He's a great receiver, Burris is. From Nashville, from Hillsburg, we talked about earlier. Junior, 5'10", 180. Third down now at about six. Burris is stacked behind Dixon here on your screen right below us. Colazo looks the other way, though, and finds a man wide open. That guy again is Taylor. Taylor showed the new weapon today. Five receptions in the first two games combined, but Jeremy, he's had a ton of them today. So much eyes on Dixon and Burris, and it's left Taylor open all day. And is it a first down? Yes. First and 10 for the Cats at the 35.
You've seen Taylor all over the offensive side of the field.
From Grandview, Indiana. I thought they only knew how to play basketball up there. First and 10 at the 35. You and I both know the Indiana coach, though. Tom's a good guy. Hope he does. They're having a tough year. They put Taylor in motion this time, bring him around. Now they're going to go a little screen pass. That's Bowles at the 30. Bowles at the 25. Bowles at the 20. Tackle from back behind him there to inside the 20-yard line. Bowles caught it. He's a big target. He gets inside the 20-yard line. Let's see where in that flag. It's probably going to be where that flag is. Going to be a block in the back.
That was great coverage there to get Bowles to where he got to as well.
Well, the Cats a little mistake prone here in this third stanza. That's going to be a block in the back. Here's a replay of it. You saw that on your replay by Christopher Reasons and the gang and Ashley Janda. Your granddad still in the baseball card business a little bit?
Jimmy?
Yeah.
Not sure.
Not sure? Okay. Well, he's a big baseball card guy one time. We used to trade a little bit. Okay. 43 after all of that. So it's going to be first down now and 18 yards, Hubble tells me. Collazo back near the Wildcat. He looks. Collazo does. On the down and out. Caught. Yes. Taylor caught it. The old famous down and out, Jeremy McCulley. He caught the 30, and then they knock him out of bounds. But that's hard to defend, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, everything we've seen today has been hard to defend on the Bluefield end of things. Bethel's just been so dominant so far.
When a co-cackless, I know it's been a tough day for your husband, our good buddy Dino, but it's been a good day as Bella won the softball game this morning. Good for her. I think they were playing another game. It's going to be second down now at about 6. Collazo out here, caught, new receiver. He catches it. That's going to be Tyler Ball. Ball has the first down inside the 25, down near the 20. Tyler Ball from St. Louis, a transfer from Iowa Wesleyan. You know, not only did Bethel return some really talented players, they get some freshmen, but boy, they did a great job getting people from other colleges. Hubble's looking for his IRL. Here is Collazo, sacked. No, he struggles loose for a moment, but a sack. Now a flag comes in. And that might be a face mask. I'm not sure. He was sacked. Who got the sack, guys? Could you tell?
43
got it. Thank you, Jared Hawk. Claire's been on top of her game today. Our spotter at the 25, and let's see what the flag's about. Jeremy, we've had a lot of flags in this third quarter, haven't we?
We have. The clock's been stalled quite a bit.
In Ellsworth, receiver downfield. They decline the penalty, Bluefield does. As Stan Gerard would say, a lot of laundry on the turf.
A lot of laundry on the turf.
Huntington with another big win last night. Hubble's on every morning, every Saturday morning. He's on the coach's show at WEIO. I'm sure he's getting paid big bucks. He does nothing for free. 5:13 left here in this third stanza. They pay you, Hub? Not yet. He hasn't received the royalty check yet.
Shrugging his shoulders.
Probably in the mail. I'll talk to Brandy. You know, Brandy and I are pretty tight. I'll talk to her about that. So the ball will be back at the 25. It's going to be now second and about 14. Illegal receiver downfield. Nicole, I know exactly what you're saying. Nicole's saying that Bethel's a really great team. And proud for Mike, but she knows that Bluefield can play better, and I know they can too. I totally agree. I said from the get-go, this is a pretty good football team. That's how well Bethel's played today. If Bethel would beat anybody in the nation, they're playing today. In the pistol, Faulkner. Then they move him out of it. Collazo directing signals to Dixon. Single coverage on he and Ball, both here right below us. Here's the pass to Dixon. Dixon caught it. Wow. Dixon at the 10. Dixon inside the 10. So hard to defend. I don't care how talented you are. That's a pretty good defensive secondary guy there with him. And Dixon just caught it on the slant end pattern. Coach Peterson down there with his very familiar hat and long hair. Still needs a haircut. And the ball will be inside the 10.
Well, you got to say that the passing game, everything's been impressive on Bethel's end today, but the passing game's been pretty unstoppable.
I don't have the stats in the second half. He was 21 of 26 in the first half. Collazo hands off Faulkner. Faulkner trying to go outside right, cuts it back inside. The ball is at the 9. He's going to get down near the 5. Getting a little chippy down there, every tackle now on every block. So it's going to be second and goal. Nicole, I got your message. I know exactly what you're saying. Mike and Dino, really good friends. They spent a long time together down there, Jeremy, before the game, talking. 8-hour drive back to Bluefield. The Cats are pretty well on this thing, 44-0, knocking on the door again. Second and goal. Hand off Faulkner, big hole. Faulkner dances into the end zone, untouched. Well, he's touched, but his progress was not impeded. At the 3:21 mark, it is a 6-yard rush by Faulkner, his fourth touchdown of the year rushing, and the Cats up their lead to 50-0. And Jeremy, big hole there by the right side of the line that time, that being Taylor, Morales, and Davis.
You got to think at this point, as a football game, Dickie V would say, he'd say, warm the bus. Well, you got to cool the bus. It's a little warm this afternoon, but they're going to have a long drive back to Bluefield.
Yeah, bless their hearts, traveling mercies for them going back. We've made that drive before. Snap back, ball down, kick up by Welch. He's pretty automatic except for twice all year, and he's had a lot of opportunities. The Cats lead it 51-0. Big hello to Bill Hamilton and his lovely wife, Joellen. Hope she's feeling better. Back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
Well, Jeremy McCulley, our color analyst today, just put a photo up on social media I was looking at, bringing already a lot of comments about Derek Hubble, Chris Nelson, Jeremy McCulley, and yours truly, Diamond Day. I'm the old man in the bunch, if you can't tell. Here is the end-over-end kick calling for the fair catch, so they'll bring it back out. I like that rule, calling for the fair catch like that. Some people don't like the new rule that was instituted a couple of years ago, but I like it. And they'll bring it out. And right now, Jeremy, it's just a matter of whether Bluefield can score. And what the final outcome of this thing will be with 3:21 left. Sun splashed, 82 degrees at kickoff, but it seemed a little warmer than that. But it's been nice up here, and we had it so cold in here you could hang meat this morning, but I know what I'm doing.
I believe the press box was about 50, 55 degrees when we got here, and I believe it's about 90 now, so we're getting there.
Wasn't as cold as Chris Marina, though, was it? Chris Marina, I'm telling you, Chris Marina is like – it's like an ice box. I like it, but some people don't. Here's the pass out here in the flat, incomplete, Nate Monroe. Bethel's defense has pretty well taken away a lot of – I mean, here's a guy that came in here today, guys. 653 passing yards. They passed the ball 326 yards per game coming in. In the first half, they had 191. A lot of those on that one play. But Jeremy's – Bethel's defense has just taken almost everything away from them, haven't they?
Yeah, I mean, both sides.
And when he's completed, he's been running for his life.
As you would say back in the day, ice water in the veins.
Yep. Here's Hurstick this time. Caught. No quit of this Bluefield team.
That's a good throw
there. That's a nice throw. That's a great throw. And Cage Chambers from Elizabethton, Tennessee. That's his fifth reception of the year. He falls forward to the 44. Big hello again to Bob Ridd, the SID at Bluefield. Does a great job over there. Bob's paid the big bucks. 51-0 here. Did a great job getting things to us. So important that you get all the information from each other each week. SIDs do so much work behind the scenes that you never see. This one is caught this time. Monroe caught it. He spun out of bounds. C.J. Bradley, who had a tackle in the first half, made that one as well. C.J. from Atlanta, Grayson High School. Second down and about seven. It's a short seven. Long six. Take your pick. 2:19 clock running. And the Wildcats headed to win number three, number seven in the country. Hurstick runs out of the pocket, running for his life, throws, and Monroe came back and bailed his quarterback out and has the first down. Nice play there by Monroe. Nate Monroe's a good receiver, 5'9", 185, a junior, Frostburg State University transfer. That's a good comeback, wasn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Bluefield, I mean, it's 51-0, but you got to give it to them there.
Cats have Braylon Jordan in there as a linebacker. The freshman also in the game is Kendrick Walker. He's a middle linebacker. Also in the game for the Cats is Marquez Taylor. Here's a pass caught. Great throw and a great catch inside the 30 and down to about the 20-yard line. Jules Ray caught it. Boy, that's a nice throw that time by Hurstick, wasn't it?
Yeah, for the first time here, we've seen in a long time.
A little rhythm.
A drop, yeah. They've got some rhythm, and definitely got a little momentum in their offense.
I don't care what it is in life, you got to have good rhythm.
Absolutely.
51 to nothing. Something Hubble and I have never been accused of. 51 to nothing. 1:14 left. He gets more airtime than any stat guy in the entire. I don't know. I bet my boy at Campbellsville gets a lot. Don't you think so, Hubble? He's well over 400 games straight. Here's Hurstick looking. Threw it away. Nice decision there. Being pursued there that time. Great pressure by K.J. Hicks. And as Xavier King still in the game, the starter. So you still got King in the game. Hicks is in the game. A la David Riggins / K.J. Hicks. In the game, too, is Jerwin Young. And it's going to bring up now second down and 10 from the 21. I tell you what, if you've got Young, Hicks, and King coming at you, that's about 1,000 pounds. You want to unload it. Here's the pass, incomplete.
Hit him right in the center of the chest there.
Right in the numbers, didn't it? And dropped that time by Lee. Slanting pattern from the left side over there, and it's going to be now third down and 10 from the 11. Soccer catch tonight at Missouri Baptist, 6 o'clock. You can watch the game and follow the stats on it on their website. It's both posted there. I have a short blurb up, too. They moved the game time from 4 to 6. So you can go to our website. Go to thebethelathletics.com. Go to men's soccer, and you'll see how you can watch the game. Women are off to the 29th. Men ranked 13th in the country. They've outscored their opponents 23-2 this year. Here's a pass. Incomplete. Tried to go over the middle this time again to Jules Gray. The men's soccer team, again, have outscored their opponents 23-2 thus far. That's pretty impressive. Almost as impressive as the BallGame Blitz and Worthy Road Studios crew. They get paid big bucks. They don't know, but I know what they get paid. It's going to be third down and 10 from the 21. Make it fourth and 10 from the 21. No other recourse other than go for it. Hurstick back there, looks, throws, caught, and a nice catch this time again by Nate Monroe, and he's got a first down. On the fourth down play, catch didn't get to him that time as much, and now we got a little chirping between Hicks. And good play there by Jordan Young. He's telling Hicks, get back and be quiet. I don't think he probably said be quiet, but something that has the same result. I mean, you're up 51 to nothing, son. No need to chirp between you and an offensive lineman. Good grief. 17 seconds. I'd say the offensive lineman the same thing. Of course, they're down there in the heat of battle. I'm not. Hurstick, he may have said something about his heritage. I don't know. Here's the pass, and it's caught. I think the pass was intended to Wolf, and in the back of the end zone, it's caught by Jordan Ebron. Jeremy, that's a strange-looking play, but it worked.
That was hard to tell where
don't
that ball
was
intended.
Don't you think it was intended
actually,
to one?
I'm not sure where that ball was intended, but
Claire
it was caught.
I think so.
I think it was
intent. He went to number one. So with 4 seconds left, Hurstick to Ebron. And in to attempt the PAT will be Isaiah Bandy. Here's the kick. It is up, and it is good. 51-7, your score. Well, Bluefield, it took them a while, but they're on the board. 4 seconds in the third. And it's 51-6. We'll make it 7. Back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
We like to protect the integrity of the game, but I missed that time, how far the drive was or how far the pass was. I said 7, Hubble said 8. And at this point in time, we both said, well, 44 yards. We both said we didn't know, and at this point, it may be academic anyway, but 51-7. But we do like to protect the integrity of the broadcast. Here's the kick back over his shoulder at the 4-yard line. Bringing it out will be Tyler Ball. Ball coming right at us. He runs into a sea of white uniforms, and he's knocked down to about the 15. So the Cats will have it at the 15-yard line. They lead the game 51-7. Back with you next week. That's the end of three. So far, so good. Bethel leads it 51-7. We'll take a one-minute break. Be back for the final stanza right after this on the Bethel Football Network.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know, caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntington. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntington, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
Well, we're back. We're back with you, everybody. And you missed a couple plays, but it's now going to be third down and about seven. New quarterback for the Cats in there. And he's running for his life right now and not getting much out of that will be Avon Rucker. Remember, Rucker played pretty well last week. The new running back in there, too, was Jordan Kaysen, who carried it. Now a flag comes in, and we've got a little hanky-panky going on in the middle of that scrub. Well, Rucker hit. Rucker, the quarterback from Riverdale, Georgia, West Virginia State University, another one of those transfers. And the flag came in from across the way. We'll follow the screen here with our replay. I don't think we can probably tell him what happened because it was one of those deals where they just all tangled up there. Maybe some verbiage and the official saying, everybody get back. Here's the replay, and let's see if we can see what happens. You'll see Rucker carry the ball. And unsportsman. It's going to be on Rucker. Rucker refused to go down. I saw him stiff-arm a guy, and it looked like it might have went right in the helmet. And now he actually, oh, my goodness.
It kind of looked like he went both ways.
That's
there,
a proper call. I'll tell you what they got him on, though. Did you see him? He tried to stomp the guy's hand. I hate to bring that up. Rucker's a great kid, but lost his cool there a little bit. And for the first time today, Braden Johnson will be back to punt. He'll stand in his own end zone and punt it. Yeah, you could tell very clearly he tried to stomp. He was angry because they wouldn't let him go. The whistle had shrilled, so I can understand that. Johnson averages 50 yards per punt. He'll need every bit of that to get it out of the end zone here. 13-25, gets it away.
Big punt.
That is a great punt. That thing is still rolling. That's going to roll to Tresman. Ladies and gentlemen, that, from the line of scrimmage, what was it, 9? Is that right?
Yeah. A huge
punt. That's 41 yards, 51 yards, 57, almost 58 yards on the punt. We'll double-check with our statistician, Derek Hubble. Well, he kicked it. The line of scrimmage would be in the 9. Yep. And the ball's resting at about the 28. So, am I correct?
58?
Was my math. My math was pretty good.
58-yard punt there. Yeah, that was a boomer.
Another unsportsmanlike.
Is that on Bethel?
Did he acknowledge that was on Bethel? Mike Jasper's not happy. Well, Bethel piling up some penalties here despite the fact they lead 51-7.
We've seen a lot of those here in the second half.
Yeah, you begin to sense when it got away, the game got away a little bit. It became a little chippy between both teams. Coach Jasper, Coach Kincaid wanting to know what happened as well. Dustin played here. Special teams coordinator, so he's really anxious to see why they call that. And now Coach Jasper wants an explanation from the white hat, Mr. Stimmel. And that's going to be – yeah, they're going the wrong way. If it's on Bethel, they went the wrong way. That's got to be on Bluefield then. The ball was at the 28th where it was blown dead. Well, that's on Bluefield then. So Coach Lutz is not going to be happy. Now he's wanting an explanation across the way. So hold the phone, as Bill Haney, the late Bill Haney used to say. That's going to be on Bluefield. 14-yard line, Bluefield. 13-13 left in the game. Clarence got the glasses out so you can see better. We're watching the screen here as well. Hersick back at the shotgun. Looks. Plenty of time this time. Got a man open downfield and threw it a little short.
It was a good throw, though.
It was a good throw. Tried to go back over and get it. And well defended that time by Javante Carter, the sophomore from Mobile. Lane College transfer. Seems like we've called a lot of guys out today that transferred in from other schools, don't we? Or haven't we?
Yes, we have, for sure.
So, it's going to be second down and 10 from the 14. Greg Lund getting ready to watch the drain tonight. One way or the other. Here's a pass out in the flat to Wolf. Wolf caught it. Tries to turn upfield. The Cats get him there, but a nice throw. And finally, on the tackle for the Cats was Carter and Brylon Jordan out there as well, but a good pickup of 9 yards. It's third down to yard. 12:57 left here. Bethel led the game 20-0 at the end of one. Went on to lead 37-0 at the break. 51-0 before finally Bluefield got to the board. It's 51-7. Hersick has four receivers here to the near side. Throws it underneath here, and it's caught. And nowhere to go and running out of bounds at the 21-yard line. A loss of 4 or 5 yards. And we got a Wildcat shaking up. Hope he's all right. I couldn't tell. We'll watch the replay here and see what happened. Here's the replay, and let's pick out what happened. I think it's Wash, the one that's shaken up. We'll double check. There he is, 21. Boy, yeah, he just was ridden to the ground, and that very well could have been a block in the back, couldn't it, Hub? Well, they're out there attending to Mr. Wash. Trayon Wash, the young man from Forest, Mississippi, East Central Community College. He was ridden down at the 20, and he hadn't gotten up yet. 12:23 left here. Let's hope he's all right. Coach Jasper's out there hovering over him as well, as you see. Let's do this. Let's take a quick 30. We'll come back with the Cats about to get their paws back on the ball, leading the ball 51 to leading the game 51-7. Stay with us on the Bethel Football Network.
Bethelville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
Well, Wash is up. Appears to be okay. We'll see if we can get a progress report on him in a minute. Bandy will stand back near his 10-yard line to punt this thing. Gilbert near midfield. And Gilbert could come out of this with great field position as well. 12-12 left in the game. Bethel leading 51-7. Bandy gets it away. And it hits a couple players around midfield. And we're real dead there and be caught by number 11, Mikhail Banks. Well, the ball will be at the 47. Bethel is going to have great field position. The reserves in the game for the most part. Well, a moment ago, let's see if I think that's probably going to be the case here. Bethel next week, back at home. Take on Thomas University. Airtime at 1:30. Be Military Appreciation Day next week. We'll have a lot of the folks from Clarksville and up in Kentucky here as well. So the ball will be at the 47, first and 10 there for the Wildcats. Leading the game 51-7. Hand off Kaysen. Kaysen, nice run. 40, 35, turning it off to 30. And tries to stiff arm his defender and finally knocked out of bounds. Right down to our right by Marquis Banks. Nice run by Kaysen, Jeremy.
It was a great run by Kaysen.
Here's the replay of it. Watch him here. Does a great job cutting it back inside. See there? Now bring it back outside. A man of many moves.
The athleticism that Bethel has had today has been, it's just been very impressive.
Watertown, Tennessee, Tennessee State University transfer. 51-7, the band's still having a good time. Cheerleaders, the sun has gone behind the clouds a little bit. That's going to help the folks that were getting a little overheated. Hand off, and Kaysen again this time. He gets it for about 3 yards. Let's give him two. Second down and eight from the 18. Kaysen says, I don't want to come out. I think they're going to bring him out anyway. Bring the new running back in. Coming in will be Dakota Braswell. Braswell ran the ball well last week. Ollie Brand, Mississippi, Peru State. There's another transfer, Peru State. James Braswell is his actual name. He goes by Dakota. 51-7, 10:42. Rucker will go in the shotgun here. Hovering over the ball, the new center is Austin Jones, AJ. Some jumping by Bluefield, and then one of the linemen come up out of his stance. Think they're going to get Sean Farham, false start. He'll come out of the game, and coming in for him will be a guy that I don't have on my roster. 51-7. He's on the roster somewhere. I just don't have him on mine. And I'm the SID. That's hard to explain, isn't it? Here is Rucker in that shotgun again. But things, so many people you're dealing with that sometimes those things happen, a late scratch and someone else moves in. Kaysen again, this night, it's not Kaysen, it's Braswell, Jeremy, moving for good positive yards. Get two or three anyway. Third down at the ball at the 18. Got to get right to the 10. Patron with a stop. I like that name, Patron.
Patron.
I'm not sure what number 12 here is doing. Sequencer Robertson just rolled over. May have just lost his balance. He says, I got to get a few more calisthenics in. It's a long bus ride home. Oh, the thrill of football, folks. Here's Braswell. Braswell, bang, he's hit. And a nice tackle that time by Banks.
Yeah, that was a great tackle by Banks there.
Fourth leading tackler on the team. They got to bring out Welch. Let's get a little practice in. 2 of 2 in field goals, one of those today. And Welch will come in and try to knock this one through. 23 yards had been his high until today. And he had one earlier today of to go back and look at my stat sheet and see. Been so many things happening, I forgot. Under 9 minutes, 27, so that's his season high. Now Bethel may have to call a timeout. They were late. They do. They were trying to get in Partee, and he came hustling in. Even though he leads 51-7, that is the kind of play that coaching staffs just do not like. And they all have to come right here and meet Coach Mike Jasper. Again, our big thanks to our corporate sponsors, Trevathians, Carroll Bank and Trust, Anchor Transportation, the official transportation group of the football teams and all the sports teams here. Mine was provided by my son, Jeremy McCulley, today. Nikki Joe Stafford, Smith & Smith Optometry, West Tennessee Public Utility District, Centennial Bank, City Floors, and State Farm. The Cats will move now today to 3-0. And Jeremy, they've looked every bit of a seventh, worthy of a seventh-ranked status in the nation, haven't they?
They absolutely have. You know, I'm not exactly familiar with all of the programs that are ranked at this point, but looking at Bethel today, competing against Bluefield, I'm going to tell you they're appear to be the cream of the crop, and we'll see where they end up here in a few weeks. But, man, it's just been super impressive.
Well, the ball will be marked at the 27. It'll be a 37-yard hash mark left. Johnson, the holder. The snapper will be Lyle, and that snap is back. The ball is down, and that kick has the distance. Let's see if it has the accuracy. It does. Yes.
It is good.
At a 37-yard by Welch. Was that Welch or was that Johnson that kicked that, Hub? Is that 34 or 35?
35.
All right, Welch got it. So the Cats lead the game now. Yeah, Welch. And Claire's right on top of it. 54-7. The Cats, we're going to keep it here, guys. Tom, our producer and director at WEIO. And Christopher, Ashley, along with Paul Schulte, Eric, and Olivia. Paul has been down to that bucket truck. He's had those end zone shots for you. So it's 54-7 with 8:47 left here in this game. Bethel schedule, you look at it, Cumberland's coming up on the road. Lindsey Wilson here later, Georgetown, all those teams. Lindsey, Georgetown, ranked. Cumberland's probably should be ranked. They're going in their action today. 3-0. Bluefield, remember now, folks. Bethel leads 54-7. Bluefield was receiving votes in the poll. They're a good football team.
They have definitely not given up today. That's the good thing about them. But I tell you, it's going to be Johnson's a long drop back.
Another touchback. Yep. And Chandler just let that thing go over his head in the end zone. 25-yard line. It would not be a broadcast I did if I didn't get the Yankees in somewhere. They're doing 6.5 with the wild card, but that's the good news. The only bad news is only 14 games to play. 54-7, but we've had a lot of injuries. We'll come back. Cardinal fans can't rub it in on me too much. I don't care who wins now, as long as it's not Boston or Tampa Bay. All right, they go with that four stack up over there again. One, two, three, four. So if they try to go underneath and get the other three to block. But Bethel's got four guys defending. Now they come this way, incomplete. Trying to use that as a decoy, Jeremy. They go to Monroe. He's been his favorite target today. But, Monroe, that was overthrown that time. Second and 10 to the 25. 8:42 clock arrested. Who's Huntington have this week up? Milan. Ooh, is that at Milan or Huntington? Oh, my goodness. You'll see Stevie Ray.
Stevie Ray will be there.
Dogs and ponies, that's right. And thought about that. Here's Hurstick up. You folks in Bluefield, that's two local schools. And that ball is caught. What a catch.
What a catch.
Great catch by this time Lee. That's his second great catch. He just went up and flat beat the defender that time. And disbelief, Wash. Also back with Wancy. Here's the replay. Watch this catch. This is the catch of the day right now, other than I think that catch Dixon made. Goes up, well defended. You can't defend much better than that. And that was actually on the coverage, Darius Smith, who's a good defender. Smith is 46. The guy that caught it is number one to our stat crew. And after all that, timeout on the field. Timeout, 8:17 left. 54-7, but Bluefield's threatening back after this 30 on the Bethel Football Network.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntingdon. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Well, they're challenging the replay or getting a replay of that. That's a new rule in the league this year. Other leagues have had this for a couple of years. Mid-South Conference went to it this year. And the tent is located in there. You're a great ball, man. What a shot. You guys were on the top of your game, Worthy Road Studios and the Ball Game Blitz. You see Mr. Stimmel looking at it. And let's see what they call here. Yeah, the Mid-South Conference just went to this, Jeremy, this year. The gang doing a great job with that. Now the officials looking it over. And Bethel challenged it. Did they think maybe the ball hit the turf or something?
Yeah, it did.
Okay, so the ground forced it. Okay. Mr. Stimmel's got his glasses on. Officiating crew's done a good job today. G. Adam Stimmel, the referee. Umpires Nathan Harris. Headline judge Josh Underwood. Line judge Michelle Single. Side judge Corey Calloway. Field judge Kyle Pearson. They'll come back out and tell us. Back judge Jeremy Beck. Game clock operator Barry Capps. Play clock operator one Adam Welch, former SID assistant. So they say incomplete. Well, so Bethel challenged it. And that's going to bring it all back. So the Lee stat sheet will not look as good as he had hoped it would be. Y'all are looking at me with raised eyebrows. Kids are now really into their stats. Believe me, I know. Mr. McCulley, you missed a tackle. Mr. McCulley, you missed two sacks. Mr. McCulley, you know. Matter of fact, we had a rule implemented here this year from the SID office level. You remember baseball. No player is allowed to contact me about stats. It has to go through the coaches. Claire knows. It's going to be now third down and 10. They go this way now. Man wide open, and he overshoots.
A little overthrown there.
Monroe. So they'll have to punt it. Secker is going to come out to receive the punt. Tell you one thing, I admire Nathan Herstick, though. He's going out, head down a little bit. He's really fought hard today, done all he can, but he's
really
just
has.
Been under the gun all day. Teammates giving him the handshake. He's coming across. Well, they should. He's a tough little cookie. Secker, well, as we said, will be back near the 40. Bandy has been out there a lot today. He's going to have to punt from his 10. Bethel ushers in Jacoby Gibson very quick on the special teams. And Bandy, who's had a tough day back there at times. And, again, not a great punt. Secker will gather at the 45. Midfield, 45. Will run out of real estate at about the 43. Forced out of bounds there by Jaden Campbell. So at the 43, Secker did a good job coming up and filling that, not letting it get behind him and take a roll. Short punt, and Bethel again in good field position, Jeremy. That's something they've had almost all day today.
Absolutely. They've been in good field position from the get-go, you know.
Sure have. So the Cats, 54-7. And the reserves, you know, they're not trying to run the score, but the reserves want to get in. Ramirez Young in there at the offensive line. Let's try to spot as many of these guys as we can. Give him a little air time, a little love. In motion this time is Alonzo Russell. Russell has the handoff, and Russell hits the turf. Great defensive play. Outstanding tackle that time. See, was that 17? Was that Bowden Nadali? 17, yeah, he made the stop. Bowden Nadala, I love that name. Concord, North Carolina native. So at the 49-yard line, a loss. Jeremy, about 6 yards, isn't it? Second 16?
Yeah, I believe six or seven there.
Well, what do you think about your debut as a color analyst on football?
You know, I'm a little better at basketball, but I'm
getting
a little better.
You've been fine,
football as well, trying to chime in when I can.
You've been fine. Great job. Looking for dinner on the way home.
Winner, chicken dinner.
That's right. Hand off Kaysen. Kaysen stumbles his way for a few yards. Gets back some of the yards they lost, but it's going to bring up third down, still a long third, about 13. Under 7 minutes. Well, the folks at University Drive, some of them have pulled over in the grass. You know, they used to park on the sidelines there, Jeremy, on the highway there, right off the highway. And the MPD didn't like that. They came out and started making people move. Some of them had their radios on, listening to 100.9, I'm sure, and watching the game and in the friendly confines, air conditioned of their units, of their cars. So it's going to be now 54-7 and third down and about 15 yards. Rucker awaits the snap. Rucker has it, gives it to Kaysen, trying to come right at us. He runs into your screen there if you're watching, and bulldozes you, knocked down the guy that came up with the tackle. He put a helmet right on Elijah Padgett, who is a really good defender. their fourth leading tackler, but he put Padgett on the floor, didn't he?
Looked like a small Jerome Bettis move right there.
Now we got a little chirping again on the sidelines. Fourth and about five. And cooler heads prevail. Nothing happened there. It's a brutal game, and the emotions run high from time to time. Omarion Harris will come in the game. Also in the game for the Cats will be Dylan Morales. So the Cats will have it down the long field. This is going to be a 55-yard attempt.
Wow.
By Welch.
That's a little surprising.
No, that's Johnson. That's Braden Johnson in there. That was Johnson, I think, that kicked it a moment ago, guys.
This will be interesting to see.
It wasn't. It was Welch. Okay, right. You guys are on top of your game. Johnson's got the leg, a 55-yard hash mark right attempt, and it goes right through the hands of Harris. So Johnson's going to run with it. He's going left, then he's going right, then he hits the turf. Well.
Really wanted to see if he had the leg for that.
I did. He's got the leg, but it goes to no avail. And now, instead of maybe three more points, and that's nothing to rub it in. They're just trying to get Johnson out there for when they might need him later. He does the kickoffs. Welch does the PATs and the field goals. So at the 49, after the snafu on the special teams, they'll have it the 49, first and 10. So 5:27, all that remains in the game. You see the great scoreboard. We haven't talked about the scoreboard enough. All the sponsors are listed up there, the panels, and then the rotating board. We'll have more added to it in weeks to come. Hershey back there looking, and is it caught? Yes. Or did it hit the ground first?
Incomplete.
No. Lee caught it. See if it stands. They're going to count it. 5-yard pickup, second and five. Hershey just had to unload. That was just nothing but a let me get rid of this thing. 5 minutes left in the game, and Bethel's going to go to 3-0, and Bluefield will suffer their first defeat at 2-1. Bethel won back in 2019, 49-24. Here's the pass. It's caught, and then hit hard. His receiver, Jules Gray, that's his third catch of the day, and he's got a first down inside Bethel's. Bradley made the stop at the 25-yard line. Jeremy, this will be now the sixth meeting. Bethel is, the fifth meeting. Bethel will be 5-0 against Bluefield all time. First met back in 2012. It's been a while ago. I think a team up north won the national title in basketball that year. Here's the underneath thrown. It's caught by Monroe. He caught it. Another positive play there for Hershey in the game. You remember who won the title in 2012?
I would say that would be Anthony Davis, Michael Kidd Gilchrist, Cal's first and only win there at the.
Well, he's going to win more.
Well, we hope so.
Second down and two. Hershey looks, throws back across his body, and that pass is down there and is incomplete. Great effort by the receiver, but even a better effort by three defenders down there for Bethel. You'll see a replay of it. They threw that right at Paul Schulte down there. Paul was ducking on the truck down there. Good play defensively. Well defended that time. Big target down there that time. Unable to come up with it. It was Jules Gray. So it's now it's third and two from the Bethel 17-yard line. Hershey back there again. Triples far side right. Top of your screen there as you see. He's going to run it. Design play. Quarterback draw. They grab him by the sleeve, but tuck him down, but he gets the first down. Inside the 15 to about the 13. Nice decision by the little quarterback that time.
He's really taking a beating down there today.
He has.
It's been tough.
He'll have to give him a seat by himself to stretch out on the bus going back.
Yes, he will.
Boy, I've made a lot of those trips through the years. Most of the time on the good side with Lambeth and Bethel. Sometimes long drives. It's tough. First and 10, now the ball at the 13. Hershey looks, throws, caught. Touchdown. Well, you see it. Caught by Zerl Ibram. That's his second touchdown reception of the day. And it's 54-13. Nice play by the quarterback and the receiver, Jeremy McCulloch.
Yes, it was. Hirschman's really, he's shown a lot of character here in the second half, and Bluefield in general, just not by giving up. Had a lot of energy here in the second half.
Bandy in to attempt a PAT, 3:05 left, all that remains in the game. Bandy will knock it through. And it's 54-14. We'll take a break. 30-second break. We'll be back right after this on the Bethel Football Network.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
Well, a lot of football around the nation tonight. A lot of football tomorrow in the NFL, something I don't watch a lot of. But, well, what a tough break for Aaron Rodgers. It's been well documented, talked about, written about. He says he'll be back for the playoffs. We'll wait and see what happens there. But who your Titans have tomorrow, Jeremy?
The Titans have the Chargers.
Chargers. That's in Nashville, right?
Yeah, they're in Nashville. Yeah, I had an invite to go to the game. Not going to make it since I'm back home. But hopefully they can pull out a W after the first loss down there in New Orleans last weekend. But I'm still optimistic they're going to have a great year.
Bandy's in over in at the 20, 25, and knocked out of bounds across the way. Is who brought that back, guys? That's 26. Is that Kaysen? Kaysen brought it back. Well, the Titans will have a decision to make about quarterback sooner or later, I think, if they don't play better than they did in the opening game. But
yeah, Malik Willis. Levis
didn't even dress out the other day.
Yeah, hopefully we can bring one of the two guys in. You know, well, Malik Willis played for Hugh Freeze, good friend over at Liberty, at Auburn.
I was in touch with Hugh. I got a good buddy of mine, Chris Mickelson, who used to be the SID at Campbellsville. I got him 5 tickets to the game today with Auburn and Sanford.
War Eagle.
Hugh and Reagan, his lovely daughter, came through for me and gave Chris. He has 3 kids, and he and his wife, the kids had never been to Auburn. Here's the handoff. Dakota Braswell hit hard, bounces off a couple of guys. Flag comes in after all of that. We're going to have a block in the back, I think. We'll wait and see. It could be something else, but the way that flag came in right at the point of attack, normally it's going to be a hole or a block in the back. Well, the officials have earned their money. They've called it tight here all day. Been a well-officiated game. I have no problems with that. I'm sure a couple of questionable calls. Now, Bethel's saying it's on. No. Dedrick Borden holding. Here it is, replay. Let's see if we spot it. Watch the top of your screen. Yeah, he was holding. Had too much jersey, didn't he? See him clear out that much sometimes. First and 20, and Rucker will have Braswell right behind him. First and 20 now, 2:35, clock running. Bethel leads 54-14. Rucker to Braswell. Coach Bright just calling some very conservative plays here, trying to run this clock out. Our next live broadcast with Bethel will be next Saturday. Volleyball's on the road. Soccer's on the road. I'm not sure what Banks is doing. He and the band have a little thing going there. He's dancing at the band there. 2:02 left, under 2 minutes now. And Bethel just draining the play clock. It's down to 15 right now. Game clock at a minute 50. It's second down and a good 20 yards. Rucker puts Braswell to his right. Shifts him around a little bit. Braswell again, far side left, 20. Hustling hard up to about the 25, breaks loose. That ball come out. Let's watch the replay here. Here's the ball game blitz and Worthy Roads replay for you. You follow it here. Braswell is going to turn the corner, Jeremy, at the 20. Yeah, that ball did come out. It looked like they picked it up.
Yeah, it does look like Bluefield picked that ball up. We'll see here in a moment.
Robertson hurt on the play. Number 12, Quincy. That's the second time he's gone down today. Quincy's their leading tackler. Officials timeout as they attend to Quincy Robertson. Hope the Q man's okay. And Bluefield is challenging, and they should challenge. That ball popped out of there, guys. It looked like on our replay that they recovered the ball. Well, as they sort it out, we'll keep it here reminding you that you can read about not only this game today, you can read about the cross-country teams running down in Memphis tonight or this morning. And you can read about the soccer team. Coach Lusk is going to look at it, have them look at it. While they do that, let's take a 30. We'll come back and sort it out for you as we wind it down. Only 73 seconds left in the game. This is Bethel Football of the Bethel Football Network.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
Bethel Football on 100.9 WEIO and thefarmradio.com. Also on Boxcast, Worthy Road Studios, and the BallGame Blitz. Christopher tells me they'll have this loaded tonight. We can watch it on YouTube. And you see the officials in the replay tent. Now, let's see what they've called here. I'd be surprised if they don't return this and let them have the ball, because it looked like they knocked it loose and got the fumble, and I think the guy was in bounds. Well, Banks and Banks, the Banks brothers, I guess they're brothers, I'm not sure, they're doing a lot of dancing out there. So they said no fumble on the play. Is that what they ruled? Third and 12. I'm really surprised by that. Unless he was out of bounds, foot on the sideline over there. We all thought up here with the replay it looked like.
Apologies. I was over here checking a few other football scores with Dr. Hubble.
Yep. Hand off, Braswell. Braswell running right at you in your living room there. 30, 35, 40. Midfield, 40, 30, 20. Braswell, ladies and gentlemen, is going to go 65 yards. Touchdown, Cats.
I think he just ran that one into Tresman, Dave.
He sure did. They'd have got him for speeding if he'd gone any further.
Yes, they would have.
60 to 14.
They like to get you for speeding over there, I believe.
Well, they stopped me one day, and the older gentleman said, "You Diamond Dave?" I said, "That's me." He said, "I'm going to let you go. My wife and I have listened to you all these years." I said, "Well, thank you, sir."
That must be why you yell at me when I'm driving you this way.
Yeah. You. Here is in Welch. Johnson, the holder. Welch, well, that's a 65-yard run by Braswell. You can't blame Bethel's not trying to run it up. I mean, that's a reserve in the game. Cats are going to come up a little short of their average per game, 64. They'll stay number one in the country, though, with this 61-point effort. It's there. 61 to 14, all Bethel. Back after this 30s, we wind it down. Get ready for the post game. Coming right back right after this 30-second message on WEIO and Worthy Road Studios.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit, call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
We talk about all the corporate sponsors here that make it possible for Bethel. We appreciate all the sponsors that help WEIO out as well. 61 to 14, Bethel leads the game and leads it big. And Johnson to kick it away. And Johnson to kick it away here. Hey, Oh, yeah, man. Appreciate that. The Hubbles are in the house. We appreciate that very much. Derek Hubble has connections, doesn't he? His family's up here with us.
D-Hub's always got the connections.
Here's the end-over-end kick. Another touchback for Johnson. Thanks, guys. 61-14. That's going to come in handy here in the postgame.
Yes, it will.
Everyone eating except Hubble. I can't believe he didn't get anything, Deke. He's probably going to Mallard's later tonight. Oh, he got something. Okay.
He'll probably be at Mallard's after anyway.
They know him all at Mallard's. He always gets the free dessert there, the pie or the cake.
Pie or the cake tonight. What is it, Hub?
Probably the pie.
Probably the pie.
So it's going to be 61-14. You folks that follow Bethel know of the late Dale Kelly, the mayor of Huntington and former athletic director here, famous SEC official as well. One of the last times I was over there before he passed away about a year ago, Mr. Kelly was there. Hershey looking, throwing, caught. And it's going to be a nice comeback catch there, baiting his quarterback out. Was great. Here's the flag on the play, though. And the tackle made by C.J. Bradley. Bradley's been very active. Where that flag comes in is normally, if it's not a face mask on Bethel, the quarterback, it's got to be holding, I think, on the offensive line. They're not real happy, so I think that's the call. Big number 55, Joe Riley, he's not real happy, but they may have got him the way he's reacting. I don't know that. It's actually 69. It's actually on Tremaine Baker. Now, replay the first down. It's going to move it back now to about the 15. Academic right now with just 46 seconds left. Well, credit Bluefield. They never quit in the game. They were down big. They fought back, but too little too late. 61-14 Cats. Bethel's defense did a number on this offensive unit. They go out in the flat out there, and it's caught. And knocked down at the 20 as receiver.
I think that's going to do it there.
Yep. 26 seconds left, and they'll probably snap it and try to get one more positive play out of it. Coach Lust still coaching hard over there, telling his troops what he wants. Well, again, traveling mercies to Dino and Coach Lusk and the Bluefield group and their fans as they make their way back to Bluefield by an eight-hour drive. They go for the bomb, and here is the pass, and incomplete. Intended pass to Agile, and that's going to end the game. Well, the happy final here. Bethel moves to 3-0, and Bluefield falls to 2-1. The Cats led 20-0 at the end of the first quarter. We really never headed in the game, and they win it 61-14. We'll take a break. Be back. Two-minute break. Be back with the postgame. Stats, analysis, scoring recap, and Coach Jasper. It's all coming up next on the Bethel Football Network.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an eight-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntington. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
Welcome back, everybody. The happy final here. The Cats win it 61-14. All Bethel in this one. They lead the game 20-0 at the end of one. Let's give you a scoring recap of the first half, then we'll do the scoring recap of the second half in a few minutes. Collazo to Dixon for 15 yards. That coming at the 13-10 mark of the first quarter. Bethel led 6-0. PAT by Welch to no avail. 9:43, Collazo then finds Dixon again for 29 yards. Made it a 12-0 game. The PAT by Welch that time made it 13-0. Collazo rushing for 7 yards to the Bluefield goal line. That coming at the 4:42 mark of the first stanza made it 19-0. PAT by Welch made it 20-0. That coming with just 4:42 left in the first. Didn't take Bethel long in the second half. Collazo to Dixon, 5 yards. His third touchdown reception of the day and the third for Collazo of the day. And that made it 26-0. Welch's PAT made it 27-0. Welch, a field goal, 27 yard. That's his season high. Had a 23-yarder earlier coming in. But that made it 30-0. Then Collazo to Partee, the tight end, for 6 yards with 32 seconds left in the first half. Welch the PAT, and it made it 37-0 at the break. Josh Key, great job, sir, on the PA today, as always. Craig Lund just sent me a message, says that you guys are about to drain something in Florida. Good luck. Of course, Hubble's a Florida fan. I can't say much. You know, I have to respect him. Right. But great job by our PA guy, Josh Key. At the 11:04 mark of the third, Faulkner, a 1 yard run, made it 43-0. PAT by Welch made it 44-0. Faulkner then with 3:21 left in the third, 5 yard run, made it 50-0. Welch's PAT, he's only missed two all year, made it 51-0. Herzig pass complete to Ebron for 8 yards. I'm not sure he was the intended receiver, but he caught it in the back of the end zone. PAT by Bandy made it 51-7. That's at 4 seconds left in the third. We spin our way then to the fourth. Welch, a 37-yard field goal, made it 54-7. Herzig then a pass to Ebron again, 18 yards for the touchdown score at 3:05 of the game. Made it 54-13. PAT by Bandy made it 54-14. You thought maybe that was the end of the scoring, but it was Dakota Braswell. 75-yard run, that coming with 56 seconds left in the game. Welch the PAT made it 61-14. Your happy final in this one. Let's take another two-minute break. We'll come back, give you a look at the team stats and individual stats. Big day for Joaquin Collazo, 27 of 33 for 372 yards. We'll tell you more about him and others when we come back after this two-minute message on the Bethel Football Network.
To finance your next car loan, come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. 4 locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required in federal insured by the NCUA.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit, call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
Are you always on the go, trying to cram a job, picking up the kids, and all of your other errands into an 8-hour day? Carroll Bank & Trust is proud to offer mobile banking that allows you to bank on the go and make banking convenient for you. The mobile app allows you to check your balance, transfer money, all from the palm of your hand, 24/7. How's that for convenient? At Carroll Bank & Trust, we're proud to offer banking options that fit into your busy schedule. Carroll Bank & Trust, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC. Always online at carrollbank.com.
We're proud to call Huntington one of our new hometowns. Now serving Huntington and all of Carroll County, Hometown Health Clinic is open on the Court Square. Featuring family practice, internal medicine, pediatrics, mental health, a Suboxone program, and convenient care. Hometown Health Clinic, staffed with folks you know caring for families just like yours. On the Court Square in Huntington and online at hometownclinics.com.
There's an old adage in football, you've got to be able to run the ball. Today, Bethel's defense stymied the running attack of Bluefield. Bluefield today only minus six yards rushing on 19 carries today. Remember, some of that yardage was negated with sacks and those kind of things. Bethel, meanwhile, rushed the ball 34 times, 199 yards. Combined quarterbacks, 28 of 34. Colazo alone was 27 of 33 for 372. Bethel had 578 total yards. Not bad effort by Bluefield. They had 369 yards, most of those coming in the air as they passed the ball 46 times. They had three passes intercepted, but 369 yards, but most of those coming obviously in the air when you had minus 6 yards in rushing. Bethel on third down conversions today, 54%. They came in at 47%. Today they were 6 of 11, 1 of 2 in fourth down conversions. Red zone, Bethel came in today scoring 12 times. They've had the ball in the red zone this year. They scored all 12 times. 11 of them had been touchdowns, one a field goal. Today they were 8 of 9 in the red zone. That stat just continues to stagger you. Bethel passing 379, 199 on the ground. Colazo, 27 of 33, 372 for four touchdowns. It was Colazo had 23 rushing yards. Caldwell, I'm not sure that was DeAndre Caldwell in there. It was Rucker, the quarterback, wasn't it? We had Caldwell in there, quarterback. It was actually Rucker. Okay. All right, we'll get that corrected. Let me correct that. Faulkner had 28 yards. Kaysen had 38, 90 by Braswell today, much of that coming on that one run. Martise Smith didn't play hardly at all in the second half at 33. Kenny Williams caught two passes for 16 yards. Dixon, 8 catches, 149, and did not play in the second half much. Three touchdowns today. Taylor was the big guy today with 9, 120. His longest was 24. Several other players had either one or two catches. Today, Ebron had 2 catches, both of those for touchdowns. Lee had 5 catches for 75 yards, and it was Monroe. He was sort of their workhorse receiving anyway, 7 for 51. Bandy today punting only 25.5. Johnson only punted one time, 65 yards. That's going to add to his 50 yards per punt average coming in anyway. And then Gilbert had a big game today as well. So the Cats run away with it. They lead the game and win the game 61-14. Let's take a 2-minute break. We'll be back with Coach Mike Jasper. That's coming up next on the Bethel Football Network.
Coming or going, the first move should take you to Taylor Real Estate and Auction on East Main in Huntingdon. With Taylor Real Estate and Auction, knowing where to begin is the key to real estate satisfaction. And no one does it better than Taylor Real Estate and Auction. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5, and appointments can be made for other days and times. So whether you're in the market for real estate or looking for an auction company, call 986-8578. Knowledge is power. Taylor Real Estate and Auction.
Doggone it. Did you forget to call 811 before you started digging? 811 is free, easy, and the law. 811 will contact all underground utilities to have your lines marked. Don't wind up in the doghouse. Call or click 811 before you dig. We want to keep you safe. Thanks for trusting the West Tennessee Public Utility District.
The Johnsonville TVA Credit Union wants to finance your next car loan. Come in and get pre-approved before you go car shopping. Come by any branch, and Johnsonville TVA Credit Union will help with payments to fit your budget. Is your rate too high somewhere else? Bring it to Johnsonville TVA Credit Union and lock in a low rate. Four locations to serve you: Camden, Huntingdon, New Johnsonville, and Cumberland City. Johnsonville TVA Employees Credit Union, your lender of choice when it comes to borrowing money. Member eligibility and loan approval required and federally insured by the NCUA.
If you're looking to purchase or refinance a home, or maybe you need a home equity line of credit, call the folks at Holly Credit Union and talk to one of their experienced loan officers. At Holly Credit Union, their goal is to provide members with low-cost, high-quality financial services in a friendly, personal environment. So call them today at 644-9031 to schedule an appointment to discuss your home loan situation. That's Holly Credit Union.
Deposit insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Visit Holly Credit Union of Paris.
The Cats win it, and they win the game 61-14. You have some replays of the final second half, guys. If you don't, that's okay. That's fine. Coach Jasper is going to join us here momentarily. as the Cats scoot out to a 20-0 lead, and they win the ball game going away 61-14. The Cats led 37-0 at the break and played reserves much of the second half as they win this game 61-14. Coach Jasper talking to Derek Hubble, our statistician at the moment. We'll get him over here and talk to him just momentarily. And going against an old foe today and a mentor of his to some degree, Dino Kaklis. And today the Cats went out and went big. Now, remember, folks, Bluefield, before you just take this win for granted, Bluefield was receiving votes coming in here today. And a good football team that Bethel just decimated today. And again, 2-0. I know the competition hasn't been super great, but they still won and won big, both of them. They were averaging 42 points a game. And Bluefield came in receiving votes. Coach Jasper's strapping it out on here. We get a few comments from him here at the end. Coach, before we go any further, remind you to send me your great quote as always. But, Coach, first of all, congratulations. You beat a good football team. I know people are saying, well, 61-14. They were receiving votes coming in here, and I know you have a lot of respect for Coach Lusk and Coach Dino, but your ball club, I mean, well, out of the gate, Dixon set the tone early with that great catch. And you were never headed today. Congratulations on an impressive win.
Man, I appreciate it, Dave. That's an excellent ball club. Their offense is, as you can see, they continue to sling it around the yard all game. So
yeah, that kid had thrown for almost 700 yards, and we were in his house all night.
Yeah, absolutely. That was part of the game plan to get pressure. Coach Springer, once again, phenomenal game plan. You know, we would have liked to get that shutout, but, you know, a little bit of clock management there. But I think we had an excellent game plan, came out and executed it, and those guys played well.
And I know you expect your reserves to play well too, but they got the points against reserves too.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's kind of where I'm a little somber. I would like to see us execute, you know, against better teams. If you want to, you know, great teams that go down the stretch there, those guys are going to have to play for us in some big games.
I said that in the broadcast. I said, Coach Mike's not real happy because we did some sort of silly things there with some penalties too when they came in. And I'm not picking on them. But the bottom line is, you're right. I said that in the broadcast. You still want them to perform up to a great degree of excellence.
Absolutely. We've said it all year. It's all about us and making sure that we execute at a certain level to our standard. And, you know, sometimes we didn't do that today, but, you know, I'm glad to get the win. I congratulate the guys. They did a good job executing for the most part, but we've got some things to clean up.
Seemed like on defense, I'm going to go back to offense in a minute, but it seemed like defense, I was calling someone else's number and name every other play, who made the sack or who made the stop, who penetrated or who made the tackle.
Absolutely. It was a great game plan. Once again, Coach Springer, Coach Kincaid, Coach Brewer and those guys, Coach Wallace, man, they were honed in all week. They had a great week of preparation. It was good for us to see us turn it on offensively. Sure. Coach Bright had a great game plan as well. But in practice, I knew that the defense was pretty dialed into this game plan.
You played in the pros. You played at college. Great at both of them. You've coached at every level. Have you had a better receiver, or you seen a better receiver than Dixon? The catch he made down here, Collazo was great today. I mean, 21 of 26 the first half. He winds up in the ball game. Let's see, what did he wind up, folks? 27 of 33 for 372 yards. But the catch that Dixon, and I'm not taking anything from Joaquin, but the play that Dixon made and caught that ball that was really, I didn't think it was catchable at first, and he goes up and gets it anyway. That just set the whole tone, I thought, for the game.
Yeah, he's one of the best receivers in the country. I think we got one of the best receivers. If not the best. And I think JT's right behind him, and so is Avant Burris. So we're blessed to have those guys on our team. And JD, he's got a different gear, man. It was good to see him get rewarded for his hard work this week in practice and to see him get going.
Taylor had 5 catches in the first 2 games. He had 9 alone today.
Yeah, he's a specimen.
He really went to him a lot because they're favoring Dixon and mm-hmm. Burris so much.
Absolutely, and that's why we went and got JT.
Sure.
We needed somebody to compliment JD so that, you know, we knew what was going to happen this year. They continue to load the box on us as if we don't have good receivers
sure.
and a good
yeah,
quarterback.
Absolutely. Yeah.
But we would love to run the ball, but, you know, we knew we needed another athlete there losing Prather. So
and Coach Bright called a great game too, and you did too. But, I mean, you had so many times Dixon 1-on-1. I don't know how anyone can – not cover him with a couple people.
I know it's crazy. I don't know why they didn't have.
But that's where Partee and others, and we mentioned they have to demand attention as well.
Other guys have to step up and execute, and I think they did that today, so that was great.
How about Dakota Braswell there at the end? You went trying to run it up. That kid deserves the chance to go 75 yards.
Yeah, and it was a great play by him. You know, you say, oh, slide, let's run the clock. But, I mean, when he broke, he was gone. There was no stopping him.
Sure, no doubt. Well, a big win for us. I know you – as much as you want to win and you're thrilled with this win, got to feel for Dino a little bit. You and he had a lot of time together before the game. I know he's been a mentor to you, hasn't he?
Absolutely. Dino is like a big brother to me, man. I love him. You know, a lot of people who know my testimony know that I was, you know, on the wrong path, and Dino gave me an opportunity, him and Alan Hollowell, to come to Bethel, and I found a home, and I wouldn't be here without him. So, love that guy today.
Hollywood just had a birthday.
He did, yeah.
I still think I'm the guy that gave him the Hollywood nickname.
Yeah, I think it was, yeah. Him and that wrestling, that love for wrestling, I always called him Ace, but yeah, Hollywood.
I guess the next question would be, when are you going to get a mohawk?
No, I don't know about that. I cut the locks already.
You did cut the locks. I said it made you look 10 years younger. But the mohawk, I don't know if you and I would look good in the mohawk.
Yeah, it's a little too tight.
Coach, obviously, I love what you say every week. If we do the things we're supposed to do, things will take care of themselves.
Yes, sir.
No
doubt
about
it. The field.
Thomas, next week, what do we know about them?
Good program. I love their coach over there. We've had some good conversations. They're going to come in and run that option.
I'm on for it.
Okay.
And then also that those guys are going to be something that's unique about their program. They built their football program around veterans.
Yeah.
So I think it was very fitting for next week to be our salute to Armed Forces and honor those guys as we play them. But they're going to be a good ball club.
I like what you've done and your coaching staff have done. We talked about this in the broadcast. Jeremy did a great job doing football. First time he's ever done a football game with me. I put him on the spot today. But I like what we've done. You get the mix of the veterans coming back, Dixon, Colazo, others. Then you get an influx of freshmen. But I love these transfers. I mean, it seemed like I called transfers all day today from successful programs in their own right. But it's a really good mix this team has gelled together.
Yeah, that's something our staff wanted to do, was to be able to fill holes. We knew we had lost that secondary and some other key point places, but we wanted to fill those spots with guys with some experience that could really help us out the gate and also bring a leadership factor to all the young guys that we have. But the way of the world today is that transfer portal, and the NAIA doesn't have it, but we are getting blessed with some of those guys who get lost in the mix.
And if you don't do it, you see teams that are doing it be successful. You see teams around the country not doing it, and they're not so successful.
Absolutely.
Yeah, no doubt. Mike, congratulations.
I appreciate it.
Don't forget my quote.
Yeah, I got you, bro.
Congratulations. The Cats win it, and they win it big, 61-14. My special thanks to the SID crew here today. My special thanks to Tom Yarborough over at 100.9, and to the gang here from Paul Schulte right on down to Christopher Reasons, to Ashley Janda, Eric Inman, Olivia Barlow, and all the gang here from Worthy Road Studios as well. That's going to wrap it up for us. The happy final. The Cats win it 61-14 from Wildcat Stadium. Read about it later tonight at BethelAthletics.com. I'm Diamond Dave McCulley. For Jeremy McCulley, Hubble, and all the gang, Austin Childress and all the gang, good night, everybody.
The BallGame Blitz Sports Network by Worthy Road Studios. With over 750,000 views in 2022, we are where you need to advertise. Please subscribe to our Worthy Road Studios YouTube channel and join the other 4,000 subscribers watching local sports.
The Jackson Rockabillys, Union and Bethel Universities, USJ, TCA, JCS, and Peabody.
Our multi-camera broadcasts include slow motion instant replay, on-screen scoreboard and graphics, and professional announcers.
Thanks to the sponsors who make it all possible. BallGame Blitz Sports Network by Worthy Road Studios. The premier sports broadcast network in West Tennessee.